How's everybody doing? It's your boy Flip Kiki here, and this is the HDL Honors Season 3 presentation thawed from my Twitch at twitch.tv/FlipKiki. I haven't been streaming much lately. I have restarted the Monster Hunter Randomizer, so go check that out when that happens. I go on Christmas break. I have finals week next week, so I go on Christmas break shortly, so content will be back up and running for the latter half of the year. Big video coming out once the new year rolls around, another one in the works, and another one I have an idea of that I want to get working on as soon as possible that should also be out by the end of the year. So some good things coming up. Also big card haul around Christmas, so also stay tuned for that. So that's a little short update of what's coming up. So without further ado, I hope you enjoy the presentation and see you around.
Without further ado, we're here. Welcome. With the amount of pain, stress, and torture that this has...
Hang on, I think you need to hydrate again.
On all of us.
That, it wasn't me, actually. It was Lion Boy.
So the Burger King franchise, it took a dip in the mid-2000s. But with the revival of the game Sneak King, the Burger King franchise saw a 40% quarterly increase in sales. And it just...
What?
It rebounded off their idea for... What?
Why? So, great pitch. Just a few questions. So, the first one. You realize you're supposed to be an announcer for an award show right now, right?
I was. I just did the whole show, but I was hydrating while I was talking, so you probably couldn't hear it. But I just presented the whole thing. It's over.
All right. Well, then I guess it's time for me to do what I do best and recap. So, welcome everybody to the third.
God.
No, this is the second. The second. We didn't do one.
Well, the second, but for season three. So yes. the second HGL Honors Awards. As you can see, we've got a little bit of extra help this year. You know, last year we just had our helper Furrets. This year we've expanded. We now also have our helper Plasma Fists.
Yep. And next season we will find a way to add a third helper. They will just expand as the seasons go on. But more table slaps means hopefully a better award show. Last season did go shockingly smoothly. It took about 3 hours, so strap in. This might take, you know, another 3 hours. So apologies in advance if, you know, you had something to do. But you're here, so you're stuck here now. You signed the contract, actually. We put it in fine print. When you signed the HDL contract to join the league, you are now legally required to stay the entirety of this stream, or else you will suffer legal prosecution. Hylian himself.
Disclaimer, Hylian Media LLC and any associated brands therein are not responsible for any sort of financial deprecation that result from a breach of contract.
Yeah. It's just like the Wumpa Fruit thing. Like, it's not our problem, it's yours. So, as we continue...
Gets gunned down on my way out. Hold up, we're not that aggressive. It's not a mob boss situation here, alright? We're not gonna shoot you. Well, I mean, we might shoot you financially speaking.
We're gonna
in real life.
We're gonna break your kneecaps.
Yeah, exactly. Right. We'll injure you. We're not gonna shoot you though. That's a big expense.
As you can also see, I am giving this presentation from the, in air quotes, comfort of my college dorm. Thankfully my roommate is gone for the weekend, so I was able to, you know, make my makeshift podium that you cannot see what it is because you could just see the microphone. So I'm going to disclose what is currently erected in front of me.
Hey, Wade, real quick. Sandy wanted you to know that he injures his nutsack on the daily.
Oh. Do a Fortnite dance. Donate money and I will do a Fortnite dance.
How much?
$10 and I will default dance in between each award.
Oh my god, now we're going to cut a pull.
Okay, well that was going to happen because you set the bar down just that low.
The fact that he was
I didn't think it was that high of a bar.
So, since I'm the person that pretty much contributed the most to the slideshow, how about I do that while you Fortnite dance, but can't screen share, so I can't control it?
Well, no, Fortnite, it's just going to be a default dance and then we move on. It's just like, you know.
4 hours later!
So,
anyway... We have a lot of categories this time around. A lot of them are returning from last one, but we also have some new ones thrown in there. we've upped the quality this time around.
Attempting
all right
to up
we've the got based fonts passed down from the gods, aka Clay.
Only
and we are going to launch them with style. So, without further ado,
we'll proceed.
Why don't we just hop right into it, huh?
We'll proceed into our first award. As tradition, we will start every
Tap and ball torture from Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia. Tap and ball torture is when you let Tep click an ice move on you in Pokemon.
You know,
when he clicks that ice move, there will be a 50% chance that Tep will press the freeze button, and you will be froze.
The dono message.
What was the dono message?
He was just describing the laws of Tep and ball torture. yeah.
All right. Anyway, as is tradition, we're starting with the saltiest match. Now, we all know the concept of salt, all right? I don't need to explain what it means to be salty. And you know what? In any competitive anything, all right, salt has existed since the dawn of time. If there was such a thing as competitive, like, handshaking, I don't know, maybe it exists. It probably does exist somewhere. I guarantee you someone out there is salty. Because you screwed up at the semifinals and cost them the game, right? It's just one of those things that happens, all right? And not all salty moments...
No, there's no and, you just keep it there, go ahead.
Look, not all salty moments are created equally. So, what we have here are the saltiest of the salties.
I mean, since I can't share my screen, I kind of have to read out every single nominee.
These are the ones that are so salty...
I'm going to yeet you if you don't shut up.
All right, fine. Yada, yada, yada. Here are your nominations.
All right, week one. The Philadelphia Flygons versus the McCallumer Picos, where the stall began. Then we go all the way to week four, where the Quick Claw Strays versus the Full Metal Alchemy. The Iron Taco stalled out, says Will to Live. Week four again, New Amsterdam Araquanids versus the Canberra Cacturns, where the nastiest of Tep and ball torture happened, and we don't want to think about that. Week five, the Copenhagen Ferrets team versus the Canberra Cacturns, where Lion Boy BM'd Kevin again. Week six, Kevin again. Tyler forgot how to meme properly that week. Kevin was not very happy. Week seven, the Florida Farfetch versus the Copenhagen Ferrets team. Kevin was tired of being salty the last 2 weeks, and that was just brutal. Week nine, me versus Clay, I just whined a lot. I was very whiny that week.
Very whiny.
Spooks versus Tyler. That should be Spooks versus Sandy. I don't know why we put Spooks versus Tyler. It was just a lot of pivot. Oh, no.
No, that was versus...
You forgot to put in the other.
We forgot to put in the other one. Yeah, we
forgot to put in one of them.
Yeah, okay.
It's whatever.
It didn't matter because this came... Why am I saying them? Because this came down to a tie anyway, where it was the week four Reggie Steel sweep and the Parahax with the Zydoge. But yeah. It turned out, contrary to what I thought, if I had to pick one that was going to be the sure lock to the easiest award that I thought was going to happen, I thought Salty Smash was going to week seven with that game. But, contrary to my belief... Saltiest match this season is going to week four, where the Iron Taco stalled out Sev's Will to Live. Tyler, congratulations on pissing someone off and winning an award. Good job. We're just going to clap all around and get a default dance for you.
Yeah. Hang on. I totally didn't forget to make the HGL Season 3 Honors Award winner roll until just now.
Do they get one from Salty's match?
You can do it afterwards.
The person who induces the salt gets the award, doesn't he? Thought that's what we agreed on?
We can figure it out after. We really can.
But Tyler, you can join call, or someone can grant his permission to speak. I cannot do that.
Don't make me fucking do the rant again. I really don't want to do the rant again. It's really becoming old.
Salt. We go to white.
I think for this one, we could just pass on.
I mean, yeah, Seva's not here. Seva isn't here, is he?
No, he's not.
Also, I think this is a category you don't really need to have input on because it's like, oh yeah, I did the thing that caused someone to get salty.
And yet I arrive anyways.
God dang it.
Yeah.
So, sorry, Sev. I honestly, in retrospect, this isn't how I wanted to win, but, yeah.
You say that kind of every week when you win.
And he's gone again.
And he's gone again.
I moved him out again.
Okay, well, we're just gonna move on. Kevin, what's up, my man? Each award, we have we talk about the teams and we go in ascending order. So, Kevin, my man.
This stage thing is kind of getting annoying.
It is? I thought it was gonna be easier.
Because of the fact that we have to...
Wrong button.
Pro tip, don't invite mods.
Yeah.
They can press jump.
I realize my face cam is now blocking the text that's going to be in the corner for each team.
I mean, usually that's not an issue.
You know, in hindsight, we probably should have remembered where the face cam was going
to
be.
There's no good corner to put the face cam, because I looked...
Yeah, because I kind of just did it however I felt like.
There's no good corner to put it in.
Well, in offense, we didn't know where the webcam was going to be on the layout.
Yeah.
It's not like it's that important, it's just you're covering up certain team names.
It's fine. We know what team it is, and you can still see the win-loss.
There's two other banners for it.
And the team roster. It's fine. Yeah. You should be able
to guys,
figure out
what
team
it is. Hey, guys, did you know that this is the scene for the Copenhagen Ferns team? I didn't realize it.
We should be okay. Kevin, hate to do this to you, because you're first, means you came in last.
Yeah.
Kind of a rough last week put you in that situation, but...
Can any of you say that you've come consistently third place every season? I don't think so.
You are a consistent man.
For the last, you mean, but yeah.
No comments.
You are a consistent man.
Though on the other hand, I will say that Wade, he thought that he had this. He thought he had tied me for worst differential
of all time.
He didn't.
I did not. This season we'll get to my slide, but I thought the record at this point was -29. To my chagrin, I found out that it was -28. Which Kevin did the last two seasons, somehow. He had finished with the same differential the last two seasons. He improved.
Consistency is key?
He improved this season by 7 deaths. Finished with a -21. The 4-9. I was expecting the last place win-loss to be worse this season. But 4-9, that means you got 3 wins. That means you're basically 3-9. I mean, you kind of have to subtract one win because everyone gets the free bye win. But like,
yeah,
still 3-9. I was expecting last place to be like 1-12 or like 2-11.
Yeah.
Or like 2-10. So it's like, still, I mean, it looks like the creativity you had with the sets, this like, you looked like you were having, like, fun with this. Like, you took the momentum you had last season at the end, and then you kind of just brought it to the whole season. Or at least that's what I noticed.
The moment I came up with the combo of Morwile and Slix Mega, I was like, I should have just have ran this season.
Yeah.
Oh, that reminds me. So, actually, I have two things real quick. So, the first thing is, obviously, you know, some of us, we tend to write down little one-off liners for, you know, the other teams. This season, I decided to mix it up, and I instead actually have, like, one question for each team.
Okay.
So, Kevin, my question for you is, what the hell was the mining supposed to do?
It was just supposed to be a fast metronomer with, like, season special attack.
Because, like, throughout the entire season, I had no idea. Like, I'm sitting here, I'm like, this is supposed to do something, right? I don't know what this is here for.
I mean,
something.
It took the I predicted that Seth would metronome into electric moves. That light was there.
Okay. And the other thing I have is that our resident Australian left me some one-liner remarks for each team. And real quick, his one-off for Kevin is, and I quote, "Sorry I BM'd you again."
No, he already told me that as well.
The fact that this has gone on for this is just so good.
Yeah.
The fact that that's passed through so many different channels, even though the person got it through the first channel.
Yeah, I know.
That's so funny, though.
I was honestly, like looking at my team, right? I was gonna say this if I had gotten the, it had been the match with me and Ray that won, I would have, probably accepted it on risk health because there's only me left. But then, I would have been I realized after that fight how much I para.
Yeah.
And decided to just, accept the villain inside of me.
So in other words, you liked being a nuisance, got it.
Yeah.
It's kind of fun.
I had enough.
Well, you definitely pissed some people off, so congrats.
He definitely did kind of have it happen 3 weeks in a row.
Well, Spooks is saying get on with it. So, you know what? I feel like granting his wish. So, thank you, Kev, my good man.
Yeah.
Hopefully see you later to accept an award.
Hopefully.
Continue your reign as the honors champion. But as we will continue, I will introduce the next award.
I thought you had to do the default dance. I thought it was Clay's turn to present.
No, it was after each. I did the default dance for the last one. After each award. Yeah. All right, Clay.
Spicy's Tech.
Yeah, sure.
I honestly, though, you should probably just read it off because the Duel is kind of hard to read.
But Spicy's Tech. As usual, qualifications. It had to actually work in the battle for it to qualify for Spicy's Tech. Not gonna lie, last season had, I would say, spicier tech than this season. I looked at last season's list compared to this one. I was like, the fuck was going on last season with this? People were trying some wacky shit. And it was
I think even in the season people did it, but it was more so it just didn't work.
I think it's probably also just because the season obviously went on for much longer than last season. And so I think it's just, people started to get even if it was to a very small extent, right? People got a little bit burnt out, and that can play a factor with creativity.
All right, yeah. So I'm going to read off the nominees. So whatever the fuck Sandy did with Dwebble week one, we just put it there.
It's funny every time I see it.
Autotomize Mega Steelix to avoid the speed passing clause. Smart play by Kevin week one. Stomping Tantrum Amoongus, used twice by Clay, actually. Acid Spray Skuntank. Throat Spray Drapion. Laser Focus Fury Swipes Zeraora. Sash Reverse Sweep Blaziken. Weather Ball Curum with 3 weather setting moves and a normal gem, just in case he wasn't in weather. Power Herb Meteor Beam Starmie. Hylian brought Mimic on all his mons so we could still have a metronome battle. Reflect Type Amistar did the week before Haunter did it, so we had to put Amistar there. Skill swap for pure power specifically, and Poltergeist Goregeist. Swords Dance plus Facade on Mew in the prediction of Toxic Spikes. Entrainment Araquanid to take away Milotic's Marvel Scale. Sash Endeavor Infernape. The Rindo Berry and Counter Crocodile specifically for Rillaboom. Culberberry Mew with Draining Kiss for Hydreigon. Yawn and Pursuit Umbreon. Duraludon did his thing. Tickle, Mimic, Pinapberry, Natural Gift, Mawile, Eject Button Sandaconda, and Super Fang Cinderace.
Just a quick disclaimer. Natural Gift Mawile did not get a kill. However, it did do 96%. And frankly, the set was so fucking genius that we decided to give it a pass.
Yep. Well, this tech, that one Spicy's tech, also didn't get a kill. And it, shockingly, only did 30%. But the winner of Spicy's tech is Yawn Pursuit Umbreon. Congratulations, Yarun. What I'm going to do, actually, is... Actually, no, I can't bring up the statistics. Yarun, you can hop in. Congratulations. If one of you wants to pull up the statistics, Hylian or Clay, from the original voting... I don't remember what came in second, and I don't remember how many votes this got, but...
Give me a second.
I think this finished with 7 votes.
So, on the original sheet, before this, tiebreakers...
Yeah.
On Spicy's Tech, Yarun won by exactly 1 vote.
Yep. What was the second place one, though?
The runner-up was Skill Swap Gorgeist.
Yep. It had 6. And this had 7. So, there you go. Yeah. That's all that. It did 30%, but it was such a smart combination, and it was used so well, and it was late enough in the season where it just stuck in people's heads. And there you go.
I'll say one thing. It actually did more than that. See, it actually mattered so much.
It did later on.
It won me the game, actually, because it did 40% to... Sarah Oro, it was just in range of a Life Orb Sucker Punch, which the Bulk Up got cancelled out by, what is it? Sarah Oro's own Bulk Up.
Yep.
So without that Yawn Pursuit on the Sarah Oro, I would have lost the game.
Yeah, I did the Altaria because then it was really hard to get certain things in them.
No worries, but thank you so much, everyone, for voting on the set. I thought it was pretty funny to do. Something sad. Saddest thing about this. This was Adamant's max attack.
That is just depressing. That is actually just depressing.
Yes. Umbreon doesn't have any offensive stats. Don't use it for offense.
I was wondering if we could just get edited like, don't use it. I don't care if it's a good cleric, don't use it. No one use Umbreon.
Use Gum Shoes, he does it better.
Gum Shoes.
Oh, Yarun, I love you.
Well, congratulations, Yarun. And with that, we're just going to move straight to Luckiest Moment.
Alright.
Oh boy.
As someone with the least amount of luck, I'm going to introduce this category here. All right. Makes it the most interesting thing to introduce. Because I know this may be a shocker, but actually, no. No, I had one thing on Luckiest Moment. It was the very last week. I was going to say, didn't have anything that was a nominee, but I actually did. Somehow.
He got nominated out of pity.
I did.
No one tell him.
But there was a lot of wacky shit going on. And one person that was a bit luckier than everyone else.
Hang on, you gotta hydrate.
A little bit disproportionately.
We definitely attempted to.
As you guys probably saw by the nominations. So yeah, we're just going to get into it. This is a new category. We felt it would be interesting to highlight the sheer bullshit that can happen during a game and win games for people. So we'll just go through it. You saw this also came down to a decent tiebreaker. So we will just proceed. Mega Steelix flinched Crocodile with an Iron Head, which let it clinch the sweep. Quick Claw Magmortar, Metronomed into Lunar Dance. Well, no, the Mag Mortar got the Quick Claw because I clicked Liquidation on my Floatzel. It got it off. Metronomed Lunar Dance, and then that Lunar Dance got passed into a Glycopod, which almost ran through the rest of my team. Not fun. Glycopod, in the same battle, hit 5 out of 11 Quick Claws, and on the ones where it wasn't on Protect, it got 2 out of the 3 Waterfall Flinches. Wild. My Gothitelle also evaded a Player Rough sweep, or Player Rough to avoid getting swept by a Belly Drum Surpluff.
He got 2 nominations then.
I forgot about that one.
I also forgot about that one.
Armistar froze Urshifu with Ice Beam, allowing it to sweep. Magmortar didn't have a bad Metronome turn for like 10 turns in a row against Spooks. I don't know how the fuck that happens, but it just was clicking the most. It was like the most perfect moves. It was crazy. See you, Lion Boy. Have fun at work. Tangela snag Nature Power boost, allowing it to get 3 kills. Miltank Metronomed Sacred Fire on a Togemaru that was switching in. It hit it, and then the Togemaru got burned, and then it died to the burn. Wild shit. Gyarados got the flinches at literally the perfect times to let it sweep. If it didn't get the flinches at those times, I don't think the sweep would have happened. Grimmsnarl Metronomed Minimize, and then dodged 3 straight moves after that. Metronome lived... Oh, no. Not Metronome. I'm used to saying the word fucking Metronome in this category. Houndoom lived at exactly 2 HP. Surlax Metronome Shell Smash twice in the same battle.
I'm still terrified.
Down,
I still have nightmares.
Down 4 mods to 1, sitting at 40%, Gliscor Metronomed Cotton Guard, and began a reverse sweep. Togekiss flinched Armaldo twice with Air Slash, and then flinched it with King's Rock Ancient Power, and then it got the boost in the same turn. Also crazy. So Valley got a Salac Berry to activate after living the current Ice Beam at 1%. Skuntank brought Hawlucha down to 3% with Poison Jab, but it got the poison, and then Hawlucha died. Prankster Grimmsnarl metronomed Self-Destruct, and it killed the Shell-Smashing Amistar. Rotom Heat missed a Will-O-Wisp, allowing Florges to toxic the Corsola later on, and so it died. And you saw it came to a tie at the end, but that tie also ended in a tie.
This happened again, so...
The tie didn't matter
because Sev tied with himself. So we said, fuck it, he's getting the award anyway, so we're just gonna give it to him. Because two things tied with themselves.
I only gave him one gift, though, because there was no way in... like any sort of reality, I was clipping all the different Quick Claws and Waterfalls and stringing them together.
It was a very long. Happening. It was like a 12-13 turn exchange with that Florges, because all I wanted to do was toxic the Glycopod, and I had to keep protecting and wishing and resetting the cycle, because every single time I clicked toxic, he Quick Claw flinched.
Yeah, that's like this gift shows. I forgot how much it.
And then I would have to reset it again. And then I'd have to try it again, and then he'd flinch me again. And everyone's like, oh, you're stalling him with your Florges. I'm like, no, I'm not. I just want to click toxic. That's all I want to do.
I also would like it to be known that, obviously, as stated, there was a tie beforehand because we had a tiebreaker vote. But just to reiterate, the first tie was also between 2 of Sev's Mons.
Yeah, but we just brought the lower.
Yeah.
So how we handled the ties... if there was a tie, and two things tied with, like, 6 votes, but there were 3 more tied with 5 votes, we threw those into the tiebreaker as well, because that's how we handled it last season. So we could just have more for the tiebreaker votes for bigger categories like this, but then he just tied himself again. So we're like, fuck it, we're just giving it to him.
Yeah, we tried.
Well, to no one's surprise, Sev won Luckiest Moment. We'll see if... Yeah, I mean, I don't think anyone's surprised with that one. So... we'll move on to Spooks. 10th place, 11th place overall. 4-9 win loss with minus 14 differential. 1 week 1. Now actually holds the record for longest losing streak in HCL history. Which I thought I had. But I forgot. We were both struggling at the same time. And then he won the last 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So he bumped it up also, a little bit.
Spooks, I think you're just going to need to, like, force yourself in.
Yeah.
Because
I don't know what you're talking about. I obviously need permission to speak.
You need permission to speak.
Well, no, because, like, the... I don't think it...
Well...
Stage channels are confusing. Let's
stage channels that. Are weird and in their beta form, and I don't know why we decided to do it like this.
It was Wade's idea.
I thought, you know, they made sense.
Oh, Discord... no! This is Discord. It's fucking stupid all the way down.
Yeah, unless they improve substantially by Season 4, I think it's safe to say we're not using a stage channel next time.
Or... Yeah, like, actually.
Sad day joined the stage when I saw him win the award. I invited you to speak, Sev. You not?
Well, you can talk about it when we get to your team sheet later.
Yeah.
How do you think your season went, Spooks?
I think I had fine. fine game.
I couldn't say fine.
Yeah. I only had 2 goals this season. Not get last, and with a better kill differential than you.
Yeah.
I completed both goals.
You did complete both goals.
He did accomplish both goals. Yeah. So, I got 2 things. First of all, my question for you, Spooks. On a scale of 1 to 10, how likely are you to draft Tangela again next season, asking for a friend?
Absolutely 10.
I would expect nothing less.
Well...
Not grab my son? It's a basketball and some Jordans.
Terry! It's Terry! Terry the Tangalock!
He's more than just a head. He's got 2 little shoes that are red.
So, the other thing, the comment left for you by our resident Australian is, Spooks, my Wild West counterpart, had a great shootout.
Yeah, buddy.
Milotic and Celesteela are fucking annoying.
That was incredibly annoying on both sides.
So what you're saying is I should draft both next season.
No. See, he does Wade. This every time where he bluffs. He bluffs the horrific stall team, and then he
Wade,
doesn't draft
it. Wait, no. Wait, stop calling him out. If you call him out, it means he's more likely to actually do it.
Yeah.
The more attention we give to him, the more likely he is to actually go through with it.
Look, all I'm saying is prep for next season by learning what the fuck Zora does.
Stall, you say? Is that, Zoe, is that you in chat?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, hang on. Spooks, what do you mean Gudra doesn't get U-turn?
What do you mean Mr. Mime doesn't get U-turn? What do you
guy?
Mean?
Oh, hold on.
Yeah, he's just A-posing on us.
I'm not. Hold on.
You were...
Let's see what happened here.
Zorak is in fact kind of sus. Big true.
Yeah. Also, for how much we joke about Stahl, yeah, Clay's right. For how much we joke about Stahl, we didn't really have Stahl until Zoeasy joined.
Yeah.
I also did the default dance, but that's... I can't.
Well, I mean, we don't have any proof of that, so you're going to have to do it again.
Did you, like, reset XSplit?
Okay, I'm back. There we go. It just froze. I just had to deactivate it and reactivate it. And
sick
we're
bananas.
Back now. So, we gotta...
All right.
Okay.
I gotta do 2.
You have to do 2, actually. Wait, yeah, pan to the next slide while you wait. I can bring in the next category.
You know, had fun. Got bitches. Didn't get money.
You know what? You got halfway there, all right? The other 50% should hopefully come next season. Maybe I'm being optimistic. I'm not. I don't know entirely how, you know, that business works.
Next season is the little cup, right?
Spets, stop getting fucking bamboozled.
Next season, little cup.
All right. Up next, someone get a janitor, because next category is best sweep.
I see my name too many times on this list.
You know, we got quite a few nominations on this one. first of all, we have Golden Gun perfecting Ultra Instinct. So, 4 kills week 1 against Jeroen. We then have Zerkatree, who happily accepts Clefable's Super Saiyan boosts. Got 5 kills in week 2 against Spooks. We have Registeel.
Smart man's reading off the form. Then I could just click it in real time.
Exactly.
Be smarter, not harder.
I have 2 monitors for a reason, my guy. Registeel executed the most boring sweep of all time with 4 passive kills week 4 against
Seth. I want to have you know, check it. That thing got no votes, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Was that the only sweep that got 0 votes?
Well,
probably actually, one other, to be honest.
Let me check here. Best sweep, where is that? Here we are. No, there's a... There's actually a couple more that did.
Oh. Well, that one also got 0 votes.
We have Gyarados.
No, Armastar.
Rather, sorry, Armastar. Armastar embraces its ancient inner Tep with a traditional Tep and Ball Torture sweep against Jeroen. We have Gyarados celebrating Flinchmas a little bit early, but you know what? Never too early to get into the holiday spirit. Got a full-on 6-0 sweep week 4 against Kalisto. Pepsi Max, you know, my pride and joy, thank you for the nickname, Spooks, reached his final form with 5 weeks, or rather 5 kills week 5 against Jack. Gliscor was blessed by the Metronome Gods and quite literally his darkest hour and clutched out 4 kills week 6 against Sev. Altaria decided to just boogie down and outspeed Beedrill by exactly 2 points.
I'm so pissed about that.
In order to just transform into a broom and sweep all of Wade's Dust Bunnies under the table.
Because that...
Getting 5 kills week 6.
That Beedrill wasn't max speed. That's why I'm pissed. Because I thought I was creeping properly.
That was horrible. Wade again. Then proceeded to just have absolutely nothing to hit Iron Defense Body Press Registeel in week 7.
Yeah,
and got 5-0 really swept.
Like a dumbass. Oh. That's not me.
And also let the serve as a reminder that Wade did want to draft Registeel.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which makes it hurt even more.
Yeah, I could have saved you all.
Electifier really appreciated those webs and, you know, decided to clean up against Kalisto with 4 kills on week 7. Kyurem decided to just peer in through the Windows XP screensaver and just go on a casual 4-0 sweep against Jack. Clefable decided that it's going to make a statement, and it succeeded because it made Jeroen regret even clicking Encore in the first place, getting out a 5-0 sweep. Gourgeist decided that in order to get a good workout, he was done just lifting barbells, and he needed to lift the entire fucking gym, which he did and killed everything, and then allowed Poltergeist to kill up the rest. Wade decided to just get swept for the 3rd week in a row, this time courtesy of Blake the Jirachi.
Yeah.
Sorry, not sorry.
Mega Gardevoir.
I could have avoided that sweep so much better. I was playing real
decided
bad.
To just come in and clean Sandy's entire house. You know, Sandy just really didn't have a problem with it, I guess. And then DNC just decided to absolutely change the entire momentum of a match and walk away with a 5-0 win week 11. And without further ado, the final one being Hitmonlee pulling up the real Uno reverse card and getting a reverse 5-0 sweep after using a single bulk up.
It was a whiter curse that I thought was a bulk up because I wasn't whiter paying attention.
Curse. It was effectively a bulk up.
Yeah.
But it got and of course, the whiter procking activated Unburden, which gave this boost, the speed boost needed. And without further ado, our winner, to no one's surprise, is Clay's Hitmonlee.
He pulled the true reverse card. I thought it was going to be Gourgeist, not going to lie. I think it was just because I didn't watch this game live. But, man,
I think this one has it more. And this is obviously a little bit of bias on my part, but the fact that he almost got away with doing the parahax thing to me, literally in the same game.
Yeah.
There is a certain amount of poetic irony there, and it is not lost on me. Also, Wade, you need to hydrate again.
I did.
Okay. I am Hylian from last year, completely forgetting Unburdened existed.
You know what? He actually didn't. He asked me afterwards.
Yeah. Yep, that definitely did happen last season. I won't deny it. Also, because you were curious, Wade, I'm going off of the form before tiebreaker votes, but before tiebreaker votes, there were actually two options that did not get a single vote, and they were Kyurem and Clefable.
Oh, so the most boring sweep got a vote?
Yes, actually.
Interesting.
At least the initial go around.
Yeah.
It did.
Well, this wasn't on the tiebreakers.
Hitmonlee
just went out right.
Yeah, Hitmonlee just decided to hit the ball running. It got 10 votes.
Out of 13 possible votes.
The next runner up was Gorgeist, but it was still 3 votes behind.
Gorgeist stays getting robbed.
Like, this Hitmonlee. Really, I'm not gonna lie. I thought for sure the Blaziken had a chance to just take this.
No.
And then Hitmonlee showed up and said, "Hold my beer."
I thought it was definitely Gorgeist, Reggie Steel against me, or this.
Like, this Hitmonlee just fucking puts in work. It's funny every time I go back and look at it. The amount of popping off that we did in chat when the match was happening. And this happened, like, it's unbelievable.
I remember watching the replay and being unbelievably confused as to how Hitmonlee outsped a Zygarde 10%. I'm like, Hitmonlee's not that fast.
Because you forgot that it got Unburdened as a hidden ability.
I'm like, Hitmonlee's not that fast. Like, did he just run no speed on a Zygarde? I'm like, what happened?
And I'm not gonna lie, I also forgot it got Unburdened.
Yeah.
Like...
Go, Shang. I feel like, okay. I know if you don't like Marvel movies and stuff, that's all to you. You don't have to listen to what I'm about to say.
I have not actually watched Shang-Chi yet, so please don't say anything.
It's so good.
I have to wait for it to be on Disney Plus because I live in a state full of anti-vaxxers. I'm sorry.
I'm just playing to get in your mind because it's so good. And I am so glad that was the time that actually Hitmonlee did something.
It was like right around when Shang-Chi came out, huh?
Yep.
Yeah.
I'm sorry for interrupting, by the way. I just didn't want to get spoiled because I do plan on watching it. I just happen to live in a state full of anti-vaxxers.
Said anything about spoilers. I was just saying I was just planting in people's minds they need to watch it because it's a good movie.
I didn't know whether or not you were going to say anything that was spoilery.
You know me. I'm not going to do that.
And, you know, we can't talk about fucking sweeps without, you know,
going into my fucking expert season.
The expert of getting swept.
Out of curiosity, what is it actually like being, you know, swept up by a vacuum cleaner and all that, you know? Never really been on the receiving end.
What do you mean? I've never swept someone in this league.
No, I'm asking, what is it like being
swept
under the rug? You know, I've been sucked up by vacuum cleaners and stuff, right? You know, the brooms are kind of foreign
territory.
Did
you watch the videos? Did anyone listen to how much anguish I was in after all 3 of those games?
I mean, yes, but that's also...
I apologized, okay? I was like, I'm sorry.
Right, but here's the thing. That's in the moment, right? Like, what's the feeling you get looking back on it, right?
I misplayed all of those situations. Sandy pivoted off my fucking ass and was completely outplaying me and got the Altari in and I didn't see it coming. Tyler, I completely misplayed my Rotom and I let it die way too early and I didn't recognize that's the only thing I had if he was running a defensive Registeel. And then Clay, I was playing pretty well early on, and then the second Jirachi came in, my brain just did not register that when that thing's setting up I needed to get the fuck out and I should have just brought in Floatzel. And when it's setting up special and defense, it's not going to be clicking Iron Head, So I just need to get Floatzel in and click Roar and get it to fuck off and then go from there.
How did Sword join this channel?
It's probably not limited to HDL. You just made it in the same, like, area.
You made it the same area.
Should have inherited the permissions from the category.
No.
No. Because,
you just made it in the same
zone. Rex joined earlier, too.
They could, they're still listening, though. They just don't, you just don't have to give
them. Yeah, they just can't.
Okay, yeah, no, I guess there's no reason to keep it. Okay.
But, yeah, this season was rough on a lot of levels. A, the mons I got rolled were fucking abysmal. Florges is a good mon if it has help. The help was sniped. So, I needed better help. I probably should have drafted a better mon to help Florges out. But, like, the whole plan just crumbled. I should have probably made a couple better plans, but a team revolving around Florges with not a extremely solid offensive core is not going to work. And
on
case in point.
On the subject of the randomizations, by the way,
yeah.
Lion Boy's remarks for you were, and I quote, his videos were a bit chaotic, like his randomized picks, but provided good entertainment.
I did try my best, and thank you for that. That was
so I feel like you. This might be enough incentive for you to do it again next season, right?
Absolutely fucking not.
I have the biggest shit-eating grin on my face right now, Chad. I'm sure you all know it, but I just want to make it clear.
I'm not fucking trying that again. Last season, I was like, you know what? I was playing pretty decent last season. I drafted a good team. I'm confident enough in my team building and playing ability. I'm going to draft a random team and build around it. Not fucking happening again. Do not even... No.
So, theoretically speaking, how much would an oil prince and Sandy have to pay you to get it to get you to do it again?
$500.
You know what? That was lower than I was expecting.
Any other remarks?
I mean, I'm
exercising my right to use this. I get paid this week. Be warned.
No. Oh my God. No, I'm not being serious.
I don't know. We have video evidence.
I was merely answering a question. That is all I was doing. But, like we were saying earlier, since I did get swept 3 weeks in the season, and I also just lost very badly to Rayad, didn't even get swept. So that's like a minus 20 from 4 weeks. I finished with the worst finishing differential in HDL history. My goal towards the end of the season was to win one of my last games and not hit 30 for a negative differential, which I barely fucking did, but I did. So Weezy might not know, but his Magnemite is the reason I have this differential right now. If that Magnemite didn't fucking kill itself like a little shitter and he let me kill it, I would have a minus 28 differential. But that thing blew the fuck up. Therefore, I have a minus 29. I mean, there could be other stuff earlier on in the season, but that was the last fucking week. And that's...
So,
I'm blaming the Magnemite.
Real quick, I want to call attention to Yarun in the chat is saying that you should join him and 50% of Clay on their monotype quest.
No.
Well, I tried, Yarun.
No. Again, $500 for monotype.
For monotype?
If someone donated 1,000, would you have to randomize a monotype team?
Yes. Yes.
All right.
Please no one do that. That's a lot of fucking money.
Fucking do it, chat.
That's
do
a lot
it,
of
please.
Fucking money.
Do not laugh. So, chat, you do not understand how much fucking content I can make on Wade's expense here, all right? His suffering gives me life. Please,
my
do
own
it.
Suffering gives me life. I have to make all the videos, Hailey. You don't realize. I might have to play Joey with a randomized monotype team.
Listen,
that.
Chat, you don't understand.
Do you know how upset I'll be?
Chat, you don't understand. The more he suffers, the less he's able to edit on his own, which means the more he has to get me to edit, which means the more money he has to pay me. So really, you're helping me out here. So please, give his makeshift editor here more stuff to work on so that way I can add shit to my portfolio. Please, by all means, just fucking do it.
Two things. A, you've never charged me to edit things. B,
I gave you the first one free. I never said I would do the remaining for free.
B, I refuse to let anyone else edit the HDL videos. I do those myself. I do those myself. Those are my pride and joy. Did I maybe neglect to just put a description in the video against Kevin from last week? Yes. And did I realize that but just not feel like putting a description in the video yesterday? Yes. But they take me like 3-4 hours to edit.
Real quick, before we move on, this is the last thing I want to say. I just want to call attention to the fact that a no mic in the Discord sort just pinged me saying, I mean, I could get a new computer, but...
But also, I just want to say, this was in fact the last season as the Philadelphia Fly Guns. Season 4, I will have a different team name, different colors, different everything. It's just... The homies, it's just... After this season, I'm good. There was just a lot of pain. And I don't want to unearth the pain. So we're just going to put the homie to rest in his average mediocrity and hopefully do something good next season. We'll see. It might be the same thing. No, Sandy, no. No. Oh my god.
Guys. Still has to pay me the money to break those Joy-Cons too. This man's gonna be like making a lot.
Okay.
Alright. TLDR. We've stalled enough. Let's move on to best kill.
We're moving on to best kill. Clay, you can. It's your turn.
Okay, hold on. Sorry, you put me on the spot there.
It's a revolving.
So we just did yours. Okay, so we're right here.
Yeah.
Wait. I should not do it that way. Someone else do it for this one. I messed it up already.
All right, I'll do it.
Highly
did.
I'll get the next one. I promise. Okay. It just threw me off.
Best kill.
I did best sweep. So this.
This is a bit of a self-explanatory award. So we're just gonna get right into it. Zoroark confused the fuck out of me. I went back looking through that video because there is a compilation video coming out after the Zoeasy video comes out. You guys will get to also laugh at my expense and be entertained at my expense. It's the best moments of my suffering. Watching that video, I was pissed the fuck off that I couldn't tell it was a fucking Zoroark for so long. It was so bad. It was so infuriating. I'm like, it's a Zoroark. Just hit it. No. Confused the fuck out of me and killed my Aegis Slash with knockoff. Dwebble obliterated Slurpuff with Rock Wrecker. Week one. Ludicolo.
He went beyond. He went further beyond.
Ludicolo got crit thundered by a Tapu Koko in electric terrain. That was just so excessive, I wanted to put it on there.
Fucking overkill.
Heracross muscled through the burn and O-code Sceptile with a crit close combat. That mattered.
I am still salty about that one. We ran the calcs after. That mattered 100%. But that had not crit me, I would have lived, and I would have killed Keep Heracross and won the game.
Yep, and that's why I put it in best kill instead of the luckiest moment, because it mattered that much. Magmortar killed Rotom Heat with a metronomed water pledge. Alolan Muk exploded an O-code Cinderace. Magmortar killed a stockpiled Chansey with a metronomed rock smash. Gliscor one-shot Mega Venusaur with Acrobatics. Sorry, Kevin, what you put was just too long and it wasn't fitting the format, so you deleted it. Weavile, X-Scissor, O-Code, a comically max HP, max defense, Hoopa Unbound. And then the next week, max defense, max HP, Hoopa Unbound died yet again, this time to Togedemaru Pin Missile. Mew killed Zeraora with its Rocky Helmet after Zeraora hit a 5-hit Furious Wipes. If it didn't hit the 5th hit, it wouldn't have died. But it hit 5th hit, and it fucking died to Rocky Helmet.
Put a sash on it, fuck!
Mega Slowbro O-Code Seismitoad with a +2 fucking body press. Boosted Snorlax killed Blaziken through sub with Metronome Uproar.
I'm still laughing every time I think about it.
Tapu Bulu used all his might to kill Greninja with Mega Drain in the below 60 base power move game. Seismitoad caught Rhydon off guard and O-Code him with Grass Knot. Galarian Slowbro killed Delphox with a crit liquidation after Jack realized that crits, go through boosts. vested with the power of Wade Luck, can, to my dismay, Crook O-code my Specs Florges turn one. Specs Florges gets a mono dark team, dead, turn one, with a crit Iron Tail. That Crook was fucking dead. Gudra got a Gooey proc and let it outspeed Arcanine the subsequent turn and kill it with Hydro Pump. Clinging on at 2%, my Floatzel fought against Wade Luck to hit the second Whirlpool it hit that game. I know, that's impressive for me. And it end the losing streak against Kevin.
Just put a wide lens on it, god damn it!
Steelix lived a plus one Earthquake due to Sturdy. It activated its weakness policy and killed Flygon back with Iron Head. Zygarde 10% camouflaged into a normal type and got body pressed into another dimension by a plus six Gudra. And Rillaboom killed his wife with Grassy Glide, therefore turning her into his ex-wife, and it completed the redemption arc, avoiding me coming in last place.
After, of course, it goes to the courthouse and finalizes the divorce papers.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's... it would have died regardless. Did we run the calc to see how much that body press did?
Oh, he was fucking dead.
He was, no.
He was obliterated.
No, I said 100%, but I don't know if it did it like 300%. Oh, you don't. I want to know how high the number went.
300 plus, I believe.
I think it was 360% or so. He died three times over.
Rillaboom did win the court case. But without further ado, best kill goes to, for the second season in a row, Kevin wins best kill with Mew killing Zeraora with its Rocky Helmet after it hit it five times with a Fury Swipes. That's our first repeat award winner, is it not?
Probably.
Yeah, I think it is. So. Oh,
probably.
Kevin, best kill two seasons in a row. This was my favorite to win. I just watched this.
It's just
this.
So stupid.
It's so good.
It's just the more you look at it, the more you realize how stupid the situation is.
It's
so funny. Going. It gets funnier every time you look at it.
And it would have lived at 2% if it didn't hit that fifth hit. But it died. Sandy, you can come in here too if you want, because this was your poor Zeraora.
You know what? Come on in, Sandy. I have to say something as well.
it's just your depressed Zeraora that killed itself.
Well, while we're waiting for Sandy, I like to thank some people.
Oh, when Kevin does something. Have something to thank.
And it is very convenient that I have to thank one of my best friends, Sandy. Because without him, I wouldn't have thought of Toxic Spikes against Soeezy.
That is true.
Thank you, Sandy.
He's also thanking Sandy.
I gave you that idea? What?
Yeah.
Really?
Yep.
Huh. Oh, also, real quick, while I have Sandy here, I want it to be known that the Mew won best kill by exactly one vote. Was the runner up was Sandy's Dwebble.
It was the Dwebble kill.
Damn it.
Yeah.
That would have been great.
It gained a lot of votes later on, I think. It didn't have many votes at the beginning, but it got a vote. Was that sole second place?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was the Dwebble kill, though. Yeah.
I just remember my heart draining when I hit off when the Rocky Helmet procced on the Mew, and I'm like, oh no,
please stop.
The worst part was that Zeraora was King's Rock as well, and it didn't even get a single flinch that entire match.
Damn.
It was great.
It was at 68, it was at 70 fucking percent.
It's like, Zeraora, use Fury Swipe, literally a second later. Like, don't do it.
Okay, hang on, Spooks just called attention to something in chat. Apparently that camouflage mattered.
No, did you do the calc that was normal type?
I don't think that's calcing normal type.
No, that's why he's saying the camouflage mattered. Because against non-normal type Zygarde, right? Plus six defense Gudra, body pressing, isn't even a guaranteed Oko. The camouflage made it a guaranteed Oko.
How did... At the same time, it would have mattered anyways. I'll step out of the way.
Yeah, like, also I think it had ship at that point, though.
No, the Zygarde was at full health.
No, it was at full. The Zygarde also had zero possible way of killing the Gudra, but it was just like...
I mean, I did outspeed, so I could have clicked Hyper Voice, gotten my special attack boost, clicked Dragon Pulse, but it was still fucking that.
It would have killed it.
It's a Gudra, for fuck's sake.
And also, it's a roll in his favor regardless.
Yeah.
It's not like it's a roll in Kevin's favor.
But yeah, congrats, Kevin. Best Thank kill you. Two seasons in a row. Pretty good one for this one. We'll see if you can win it three seasons in a row next time. Also, sorry, Sandy. But, yeah.
Yeah, you moving get 50 on. Points.
Moving on. Moving on. Moving on. Moving on.
Oh, hey. Hylian. It me and both, other me.
And other me. So both
Because fun
both
fact,
me's.
We're both named Ben.
I did not what? Know that.
Yeah.
Oh, you kind of have Hylian stats there, huh? Oh. I didn't realize you put them there.
So, for context, obviously, it's
I mean, I put the win-loss for everyone because it just looked better. But
wait, you had one job.
It's fine. This was a different slide. So, it's like...
So, obviously, it's common knowledge at this point that, you know, real life got in the way, unfortunately, halfway through the season. I was having a good time. I really was. But, you know... Real life comes first. I had to get priorities in order, and so unfortunately, I had to
Kevin, I
withdraw halfway through the season. And you know, other Ben graciously took up my now vacant slot, and he did a really good job. Actually, I'm very impressed by how
he played the stall.
He also went 1-5.
He also won.
Right, but I am very impressed with how he just sort of naturally eased his way into the whole group dynamic. Right, he fit in. If you didn't know any better, you would have thought he was here the whole time.
That's
like,
true.
He really just sort of melded right in with the group, and that really impressed me. I will say, much like Wade, this is the last season. You will see the Bronx Blaze again.
Oh.
I am also getting a rebrand next season. I haven't told anyone this.
I did not know that.
I told no one about this. This was a surprise. I don't have a logo to show you guys just yet, but the name has been finalized. And
I have a logo for mine.
You will see a new team. And with it, a new name and a new lease on life next season.
And an even faster team.
I mean, it could be faster, it could be slower. I might just nix the entire speed. I really did enjoy Operation Eurobeat. I thought it was... You know, whether or not it was effective is left up to interpretation, but it was absolutely fun as hell to do and to use, and that's what mattered to me.
I mean, you did win three games with it.
It was fun as hell to use. I loved that idea. It was really fucking fun. I really want to do it again next season, but I doubt I'm going to get away with it next season. But it was really fun to use in the moment. And that's really what the plan was. So in that regard, it was a success.
You're all idiots. Gliscor noise. How about you, other Ben? How did you feel it went? How was the experience?
Only thing that makes me sad is that I couldn't reach 200 rounds of stall. And
no,
so that's the bar I gotta set for next season.
Hey, I ended my battle with Spooks on turn 69. I don't remember if people remember that, but
that is a nice
69.
You didn't do it on purpose, and you fucking know it.
I didn't do it on purpose. I played it off like I did. But... I did not do it on purpose.
Oh.
I said it in the video. Like, totally meant to do that.
I almost completely forgot. Here is Lion Boy. Lion Boy combined his remarks for both of us. So, I'm just going to read this verbatim. For Hylian, stop accepting day one battles.
Yeah.
Actually.
Learn from Sev. He accepted a day -7 battle.
Yeah. for So Easy, congratulations on being one of the few people to beat Sandy.
That is
yeah.
true.
Yeah! He was actually, that's a...
Those are the only kills Mega Gardevoir ever got.
Yeah?
All four of them.
Mega Gardevoir got more than that. Because they swept and they also took out some kills in
I fucking love minute. That you named it ex-wife. I was silently laughing every time it ever did anything.
it's just
so good. Also, I'll bring attention to it later, but there's a very funny factoid I want to share about ex-wife later on in the awards, and it's going to be great.
Oh, no.
I could read this one off now, because I have... Right.
Moving on to... Most improved. Oh, this is
I'm gonna be honest. Even with the however much sugar coating that I can do for this, I feel like people know who the top two are that are voted.
That is true.
So let's just go over through the list. First off, we obviously have Wade.
No, I don't think I've ever gotten a vote for most improved.
Then there's Lion, Tyler, Rune.
I think you're Rune.
Sandy,
voted last season, but that was it.
Me, Jack. Highland, and Kevin Spooks.
Yep.
And then I, to no one's surprise,
Jack won again. Let's go, BB Puggers.
Yeah, Puggy. We really have to, like, regardless of whether or not Jack shows up next season, we have to put in sort of a silent rule here to where we can't nominate him for this category anymore because he will run away with it every time.
It's also a thing of, like, it wasn't a landslide like it was last season. This, like, hold on, this is, something I'll pull up
Jack
real quick.
Jack got four, and then Clay, you got three,
I
right?
got three, I got, like, three, I think?
And then Kevin got, like, two.
So it is,
I
have them pulled up right now.
I can't.
So, Jack won with four votes. Second place was actually a tie between Clay and Lion Boy. Both of which had two votes.
Yeah, okay, that's what it was.
And then third place was a tie between Yarun and Kevin, both with one vote.
I just love that that is true. That is true, Sandy. I don't know if he's going to change the colors, because he did change the colors for this season.
He did
to
change the
wide Bidoof. Oh, he should add, like, one extra Bidoof every season. But I don't know if he's going to play.
Who voted for you? Hang on, I can actually check that.
I don't know who... I think Sandy... No, Sandy voted for you, Yuru. I remember. It was Sandy.
Yeah, it was.
Because Sandy made the... So we had to,
he
we
did come
Sandy
in sixth place overall
voted.
With a monotype team. That it is fair.
Yeah, that's what it was. I love democracy.
I mean...
Also, he didn't care for half of it. That's why I didn't vote for him.
Yeah, I didn't vote for Jack either. I voted for Clay.
I didn't vote for Jack because I knew he was going to run away with it and I wanted to give someone else a chance. I voted for Clay.
Jack does so much random. He does so much random shit that anything he does looks like an improvement from season one or the previous season. Because he just switches how he plays every single time and it just looks like he's doing something different.
Let me just put this into perspective for a second. Season two, obviously, he was learning a lot of the ins and outs of competitive battling.
Yes.
This season... Yes, he has understood a little bit more, but the fact that he didn't know what reversal was at face value...
And he also didn't know that crits went through...
Also limits. Crits going... That doesn't seem improvement.
He didn't know crits ignored stat changes.
I just don't think that's, like... It's fine. He definitely did play better when he did play better, but I just find
Jack
it annoying.
Use Little Cup next season and see if he can still improve.
I just find it a little bit annoying in this kind of context, because he's still making the same beginner flunders, and yet he's still being the most improved, even though he's probably still at the same level.
I think in some like ways how he played the season in the games he was playing, I could very much see the argument for him winning most improved and be okay with it. Like,
yeah, no, like I said, he earned it. I'm not taking that away from him. I was just ranting a little bit because of how this is such a broad and very loose.
It's an interesting category. But there will be a lot more people in the category next season if a lot of the new people also participate next season, like if Zoizi and Kalisto participate next season, they will now also be roped into the most improved category because now we have a season for them to improve off of. So, you know, just stuff like that. So, moving on, it's just his team. It just worked out that way. Moving on, he is not here though. So, Hylian does not have a question to ask him.
I don't, but I do still have Lion Boy's remark.
You can still say what your question was.
My question for him was going to be, how do you plan on going less janky for an element of surprise, or what the hell is the game plan for next season? But, you know, I'm pretty sure I know the answer to that already. I think we both do. Lion Boy's remark was, good luck in the playoffs. Hopefully we will play in the semifinals.
Interesting. I legitimately do not know if he'll be playing next season or not. No one knows. He didn't even show up to a game this season.
We were really expecting to put Zoizi as the 8th seed.
Yeah.
Because Jack wasn't here for the week prior, and he waited till last second.
We had a whole contingency of, like, if he doesn't show up to the next week, we're just saying he's disqualified from playoffs, and then the 9 seed gets the 8 seed, and that would have been Zoizi no matter what. So,
yeah.
That was... We were ready to do, but he showed up.
Hopefully that doesn't... It didn't come to that, which was... Yeah.
All right. Moving right along.
Moving on.
I actually have the spreadsheet pulled up here for the list.
You could tell the facts afterwards. I'm reading it out.
Okay.
Well, I was going to list out, like, the transactions because...
Clay's looking at it. I think. This one was a pain in the ass to put
on the sheet. The freaking... I have the screenshot of what we attempted to do for this one. And it was a mess.
It was. So, just read out the transactions.
So, for Wade, he traded Aegislash for Rillaboom.
Yep.
And Vileplume for Dewblade, as well as Mega Absol for Beedrill week 5.
Yep.
And then he made the good market decision of investing in Wumpafruit week 6.
Yep. Whole team.
And week 8 dropped Tyrantrum for Duraludon. And that's all the other ones that he has.
Sylveon for Nihiligo.
Lion Boy dropped Claydol for Sandaconda, Gigalith for Rotom, Roseweave for Indeedee Female, which is kind of crazy that he picked up Indeedee Female and how much it did.
That's getting a tier bump next season.
Avalok for Cracknell, and that was all done in week 4.
He no trade. We should have put he no trades on the list if they didn't trade.
We actually should have.
We'll bring it back next season.
We will bring the Hino trade back. We'll give everyone their own slot on the stock exchange, and if you don't do anything, we'll just change it to Hino trade.
It's another word each one. So, like, the first row is he, the second row, no, the third row is trade.
So, we don't have Zoizi, obviously, didn't make any transactions. So, we have Hylian with Gliscor for Zygarde, Latias for Jolteon, Shenanic for Comfey, Darmanitan Galar for Obstagoon week 2. And then week 4, he traded the Zygarde for the Gliscor. Again.
Errors were made.
That Duraludon did do his thing. It was the only thing he did.
Me, I was probably the most active when it came to transactions and trades.
Just a little bit.
I dropped Ditto for Gyarados.
Thank God.
And Honchkrow for Hydreigon week 2. Because
good choice.
Ditto, I picked as a panicked option and I didn't really want to use it. Then Ariados for Alcremie. And then I traded Muckalola for Sandy Salazzle.
Good pickup.
I then dropped Palpitoad for Hitmonlee. And then I traded Snom and Rapidash to Spooks, who then gave me Mega Slowbro and Haunter.
Who uses Haunter, though?
Spooks. Not Spooks. Clay did. I still, to this day, remain the only person that Haunter has basically done anything to.
Yeah.
He crippled two
of my fucking Emperor Palpitoad.
Yeah, it wasn't bulky enough for what I wanted to do. Sandy also is a very active person. Most, I feel like anyone that's traded has a lot of more transactions. Sandy obviously traded Slazzle to me, week 3. Then for week 4, because he had to sit on it for a week, he dropped Muckalola for Decidueye. And then week 5, he dropped Mega Gyarados for our Mega Altaria, Donphan for Suicune, and dropped Togedemaru for Steelix. Then moving
week 2, right?
Next one, Kalisto. I'm so sorry if I butchered that. Dropped Magnezone for Skarmory, dropped his Blastoise for Zerkatry, and missed Magius for Jellicent all in week 2.
All good moves.
All of those were superb to his team comp. Kevin, oh boy, here's another long one. sorry. Kevin dropped Squirtle for Hudtail. And just the fact that you pick Squirtle still to this day, it's just so.
As that for Squirtle showed up for one match, got its ass beat, and then said, "I'm out."
So Squirtle was dropped for Huntail, and then he had Azelf, and he dropped that for Gliscor, week 3. He dropped his Poltegeist for the Muckalola that was now dropped, week 4. Traded Gliscor for Zygarde 10% for Hylian, week 4 as well. And then dropped Berserker for Minum, week 5.
Like,
on another level of just really good transactions, we go to the Quick Claw Strays, which Sheninja, he dropped Sheninja for Rhydon, Obstacool for Snorlax, week 2. Then dropped Dragapult for Togekiss, and Articuno for Electivire, week 7. Pretty much all 4 of those are like were mainstays to his team comp for the rest of the season. Tyler dropped Slowbro, normal Slowbro, for Arachnid, Staraptor for Tornadus Therian, and Manectric for Raichu, and week 6. And all. Yeah, all week 6. Then finally, to end it with probably the longest one, because oh my god, these are. He dropped Dreadnought for Arbok, week 2.
Right on.
For Alligator for Lucario, week 3. Arbok for Haunter week 4. He actually just picked it up week 2 and then immediately dropped it 2 weeks later. Chansey for Milotic. And then he obviously traded me Mega Slowbro and Haunter, and he got my Snom and Rapidash.
Richer than a bitch. I'm getting green like a Flygon. If your woman want a rock,
he had this written out.
I'll
he
give her
planned.
Something
he has a
she can ride on.
He's fucking going off of this. He had this planned. There's no way he thought up with this on the spot.
And we got Clay to read it because best general manager went to Clay himself. Clay now with, is this your third award now?
Second.
And my math is, I don't even remember. I feel like 2 people have won awards so far. But yeah, Clay, best general manager. I think he got 4 votes. Oh no, this came to a tie, didn't it?
So
yeah, we had to actually put this
initial,
up back to
self. On the initial vote, it was a tie with 4 votes each between Clay and Sev. And then on the tiebreaker, Clay won.
Yep.
Also, to answer your question, Sandy, Mew has a blunt because he's a mob boss. He has to smoke that joint.
He does. He's just having a good old time, going back to the misses. He's got a nice good old night with the misses, you know?
Name's Mew, Private Eye. What's
just a distinguished gentleman right there. Look at him.
That's the cigar, yeah, that's the cigar.
He walked into my room, cold, hot, missing his soul. He's home with
I mean, obviously,
cigarettes.
Before we move on just real quick, I feel like a lot of people could have won this and have content, obviously Seb contended because all of his mons were insanely good for him, so is Kalisto's. But I feel like it was more so for the improvement of their team and not sort of the adaptation of the team.
Yeah,
because I had to fix pretty much my half mono poison team that I had created. And I think I did a pretty good job at it at the end of the day.
Worked.
Yeah. Okay.
I was just gonna say, if anyone would have voted for me, I'd have scolded you live right now with complete utter disappointment. Because like the only reason you would have voted for me is because of the Wumpa Fruit thing. And even then still been upset.
About that, Wade.
What about that?
You sure you don't need to double check?
Pretty sure
form?
Someone voted for that just for the sake of
someone
sure
voted you for me?
No, no one actually voted for you. I just wanted to try.
I was
going to
say, I don't think anyone did.
No one was that. You do need to hydrate, though.
I'm out of milkshake.
Hold on. Hold on. Switch the slide. We'll switch the slide first because we can talk about this.
So it was Oezy's hydrate. Let's get it. What's the... what's your drink of choice? We got coconut water, we got normal water, and I have a half gallon of milk.
That's the fact that he's actually... He says coconut.
Coconut.
The fact that he just doesn't work like that. Just as he's speaking, yeah. All right, so...
Seth.
Moonlight.
Seth. Seth here?
No.
He can join call if he wants.
I don't think he was here for a bit. I think he had to go do something.
So...
Yeah.
Yep.
I will say... Actually, I sat there for a literal day trying to think of a good question for Seven. I couldn't think of one. So I instead wrote down a remark for him, and that was that this man, obviously we all know that Sev radiates chaotic energy. That's just what he does, right? But to be able to channel it as effectively and as efficiently as he does, it's something that probably happens once every 1,000 years, and it should be respected as such, because, oh my god, the things his mons have done.
I was about to say, just like, even the wins that he got because of it.
Yeah.
I can't say anything on the matter,
like,
though.
People let him do that, is what I'm gonna say.
It didn't make it any less funny.
Okay,
I don't care what you say.
Okay, so I'm breaking this up. Me, at this point in the game, in the week schedule, I had already been locked into playoffs, and I didn't care about seeding.
Yeah.
So when I went to fight Sev, I wanted to do the dumbest stuff possible, but it was still realistically stuff that would win me the game. I didn't purposely build stuff that was subpar.
Yeah.
I just didn't get to show off what I wanted to do, need to do to win the game, instead of just what happened.
Here's my analogy for how people treated Sev in this league, right? Sev is a crazy homeless person in Brooklyn, right? And they're, like, walking around, like, trying to talk to people. Usually, you ignore them. Or just, like, kind of be like, yeah, hi. Just acknowledge them and just kind of hope it goes along.
I'm sorry, I had to call you out of your bullshit, and that's only because you brought up Brooklyn and I feel targeted. That's just not how that works.
Okay, the West Village. Is that better?
Thank you.
You're in West Village.
Brooklyn, you're gonna get that shit beaten out of you.
I know. Some of my friends almost got shot in Brooklyn because they antagonized the homeless guy. And he was gonna cap their ass. It was a great story.
Like, if you see someone crazy who's homeless in Brooklyn, you run. You don't even give him the time of day. You get out of there.
Okay. West Village. The people that go around saying, like, hey, you want to see a magic trick? And you're like, what the fuck? What do you mean magic trick? Everyone here said yes. Sev is that crazy homeless guy walking around like, hey, you want to see a magic trick? And we said, like, yes.
Hey, kids, I want to see a dead body.
And gave him the opportunity. And then we were just stuck there and forced to watch him attack.
Let me answer your question. Well, your better question. You want me to see you drink this guy?
So,
my sister got chased by a hobo with an orange. Wow.
We'll save that for after the stream. There's a story there. Anyway.
Someone I know that goes here, he worked at a Regal. That reminded me, he works at a movie theater. Or he worked at a movie theater back in California. Supposedly, a crazy lady tried to assault people in the theater with an ear of corn. She was running around with an ear of corn, trying to assault people with the corn. Like, she was whacking people with this ear of corn in her hand. He said that. We were all just like, what? And then he has video. He has a video.
Oh, my God.
For, like, this crazy lady screaming with an ear of corn in her hand, like, trying to, like, smack someone with it.
So real quick, before I get my rebuttal of that, real quick, Lion Boy's remark for Sev was, quote, I liked the randomness and the chaos of the metronome. Or sorry, the metronome because you didn't spell it right. So the rebuttal to that is that just has me flashback to, I think a year ago, I was the groomsman for my childhood friend's birth's wedding. Uh-huh. And so I was up in Jersey for a week on a week-long bachelor party. And we rented out an Airbnb next to a pier. It was really nice. And at one point, we're just walking down the pier, you know, people are coming and going. And we literally see one dude who's just on like those, you know, those like little, like those like roller boards, right? Yeah. Where it's like a scooter, but it doesn't have a handle. So it's just entirely like weight oriented.
Yeah. Hoverboard.
Yeah. Or yeah. So he's on one of those, and he's got this fucking massive python.
Oh.
Wrapped around his neck. And what? I'm talking absolutely massive. Like, you could fit this thing into a metal pipe. That's how big it is. Like, yeah, we're talking boa constrictor. Like, girth. And he just has
girth.
He just has this thing wrapped around him like a scarf. And it's just chilling, minding his own business. And he's just rolling around on this roller board with this giant fucking snake around him. And nobody is freaking out. Everyone's just walking by. There are people who are stopping, just like getting pictures with this dude. Like, he's super chill. I'm like, no one's questioning this. Really?
Well, I think this is
part of the course for you guys. Like, nobody, none of you are freaking out. Like, okay. What is this guy walking around with this big ass snake? No, none of you are freaking out. Okay.
Moving on. It's funny because even in Discord, we are not reacting. We're reacting the exact same way. So anyway, continuing on.
To the one week wonder.
All right, the 1 week wonder. This is a new category.
New category.
So we've got quite a few nominations for this one. We have obviously My Shinotic. The criteria for this category, by the way, is the mon had to have done something on a week and then basically ceased to exist after that. Just did nothing else of merit past that. It did the thing and then it's gone.
Yep.
So we have My Shinotic from week one. We have obviously My Blaziken. Got the reversal sweep and then just really didn't do anything else. We have this My Zygarde 10% for the brief amount of time I had it this season. We have Snazzy's Mega Gardevoir.
Yep.
We have Clay's Gyarados. We have Clay's Alolan Muk, who went boom a couple times and that was it.
I dropped once.
We have Clay's Hitmonlee, who, well, we all know what that did at this point. We have Sandy's Mega Altaria. We have the Brooklyn Bayonets Weavile. We have Sev's Mega Alakazam. We have Gliscor when it was owned by Kevin for a brief amount of time. We have Tyler's Gorgeist, which, you know, as we all know, yeeted the gym into space. We have Spooks' Chansey. We have Spooks' Tangela, which, you know, Terry is a menace. I don't care what anyone says.
Terry!
And then we, of course, had Spooks' Snom, specifically when it was Mega Steelix.
Because that was the only week that did something, wasn't it?
And the winner, to no one's surprise, it gets another award. Bring out the Hitmonlee.
He's back. Shang-Chi
is
back
for more.
I don't know if we should put a clause in for future awards.
That would just be like way too
about
controlled over it at that point.
It's just like, I don't, just like,
because it's not, people voted this in, and it's not like people didn't want this in.
That is true.
So it's like, it's not like we could take that away.
You didn't think this should have been nominated.
I didn't personally want this to 1 week wonder, but that's just because of my bias towards this category as a whole. Not biased. Opinions on those categories as a whole. But, I mean, gives me another chance to plug Shang-Chi.
It does.
So, you know,
go watch that.
Clay's walking out of this with three awards under his belt.
For Clay. Hitmonlee,
you could have three awards too if you just watch Shang-Chi.
I would if I could, Clay.
Sounds like someone that doesn't want three medals.
No, it sounds like someone who doesn't want to go into a movie theater when he lives in a state full of anti-vaxxers.
That is true. But I thought Gorgeist and Blaziken were also front runners for this category. I realized Hitmonlee had a shot once I realized how much people liked the Hitmonlee. Then I'm like, okay, yeah. Gorgeist, yeah, Blaziken for sure. But
again, I thought Blaziken had this in the bag, and then Gorgeist happened.
Yeah.
And you know, I thought for sure Gorgeist is going to be a serious contender. And then Hitmonlee happened, and at that point, I knew I lost. Hitmonlee just had it. There's no way. There was no way anything else was going to. I thought the Gorgeist was the only thing that was going to stand a chance. I'm surprised that in the first round, like the first go around, because this was one of the tiebreaker ones.
No,
the first go around, Blaziken. Was it not? I thought
no,
it was.
No, it just went out right again.
All right. Yep. Well, then.
One vote, though.
No, two.
Oh.
I was surprised that Blaziken was the runner up by two. I thought for sure Gorgeist was going to be the runner up. I thought Blaziken was going to get third.
Gorgeist low key got robbed. It didn't win a single. Yeah. It was.
It probably should have won at least one of those.
It should have won
at least
Best Sweep, One Week Wonder, or Best Tag. It should have won one of those three.
Gorgeist only got two votes. It only got two votes.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Like, that is really fucking surprising to me. I thought for sure Gorgeist was going to be the one that was going to give Hitmonlee a run for its money.
Yeah. But, these results are surprising sometimes.
Yeah.
So, with that, we're going to transition into the boy, Yarun.
That is still homeless.
He is, I mean, not if he wins. He could take the house back.
He can, but for right now, he's still homeless, man.
He has to beat Tyler to get the house back.
No, he just doesn't win the tournament because it's just, it's not, Tyler isn't holding it. It's just the tournament prize.
So, Yarun, I'm gonna get into this right now and then I'll let the others, you know, make their remarks. So first things, my question for you, in the hypothetical situation that, you know, you win and you get the deed to your house back, I'm expecting a lot of renovations to be made. Do you have anything in mind?
I'm going to use Skarmory's power from season one, basically restore my house back to full.
To back to its full glory.
Right, but like, are you going to take the opportunity to basically make, like, you know, any improvements, right? Maybe like a new, maybe a larger backyard, maybe a pool, right? Like, what, have any long-term plans?
I actually was thinking of getting a little pond because Karens have been knocking on my homeless door. So I want the pet shark to defend myself from him. I call him, Mega Ben Sharpedo.
Sharpedo! I like it. And the other thing I want to say real quick before I hand it off to the other two, Wyan Boy's remark for you is, and I quote, "I got lucky against him in that battle, so please be gentle on me."
Please be.
I'll try.
So, I have something to say about this one in particular, because Yuren was, when he actually committed to Mono Dark, I already picked Jirachi. But I love poison type, so I was like, you know what, I'll make it like a 50% mono type team and see how that shakes up, because the fact that you're in playoffs with Rune is outstanding.
It's already obscene, and he's also the sixth seed, and he also beat seven people.
My amount of respect and admiration for Yarun in draft-based formats was already super high.
Yeah.
It just broke
and
the roof.
This just shot it through the roof.
And I knew damn well he was not going to make a team change. I'm like, he's going to stick with whatever he drafted.
You
he's
commit.
Just gonna deal with
you
it.
Commit.
He's just
also,
gonna...
Yarun, pun entirely intended. You're welcome.
The beginning of the season was shaky, but I'm like, he's going to figure out how this team works and how to use this team. How it's meant to be used, and he's gonna get on a hot streak going in late in the season. I was saying this in like the first 3 weeks. I'm like, you're gonna piss this man off, and he's gonna learn how to use this team, which he did.
Okay.
Yeah.
In my defense, when he came to me saying, "Do you want to do monotype stab mons battle?" I didn't intend for this. The repercussions of it to happen afterwards of me making that document. I didn't expect to actually care that much. I didn't expect to actually care that much about it. But I did.
Every single
and
possible.
I just want to say again, I apologize for any other mishaps that document has caused.
So, the one thing I will say here is, like, it says a lot when at the beginning your room went from being literally afraid of everyone else's team at the beginning of the season to single-handedly making it to where we are going to have to put out a vote to determine the fate of Urshifu next season.
Yeah.
This man turns the entire situation around.
Legitimately embarrassed me with how well he uses Urshifu on a monotype fucking team.
Yep.
Embarrassing me.
I'm going to be completely honest. After the performance the first half of the season, I thought Yarun was actually not going to make playoffs for a while.
I didn't either.
And then he just said, I refuse to accept this, and he just dialed it up to 11. He just didn't care.
I mean, my Urshifu didn't get many kills. It did. I did make sure when he was starting to pop off with Urshifu to look back at my thing.
What's up, Garen?
Okay, so a few things. First of all, Clay, I respect the hell out of you when you draw the top poison. That's why I wanted to do stab month in the first place. Second of all, you know what's the most insane thing about this team? Nobody thought of me as an emo kid for drawing Modok, but the second most amazing thing is that I would have made Top Cut in any other season because I got 6 seeds.
Wait, can we talk about that for a second? How did no one make emo jokes about it?
Honestly, I didn't do it because I thought it was... My brain just sort of associated with like the low-hanging fruit that comes with that, so yeah, I just didn't go for it.
I wasn't expecting
just think about it. He really did just draft Mono Edge.
I didn't do it because I thought it was too obvious of a joke to make.
Morgrove, the literal team that is coming.
And he is helping.
Don't worry,
cut my life into pieces. This is my plastic fork.
I will say one thing. I'll go back to a normal team next season, so yes, this was a face.
It's not a face!
Just cut my life into pieces. This is my plastic fork.
So we could actually label this as like as a me and your roots emo face.
Literally trying to monetize. So I'm saying, this is completing the opening arc. Like, Rune's ending with his face, he's starting again for the next arc.
That's true.
Yeah.
But yeah, initially I was not heading for championship. Like, if I made it to Top Cut, I said I was gonna go all out, but then I lost a few times and then I realized something about myself that I always knew. I hate losing.
I also hate losing. So, but I was like, I hate losing. I got swept
now
two
that's
more times.
Relatable.
That's
on a spiritual level.
So I said, fuck that shit. I'll just grab a few wins. Going to Top Cut. Going to Top Cut with a monotype team. Probably will lose in Top Cut. But if I win, I'm holding this shit over your head.
You should.
I know that, guys. You totally
we will hold
are
it. We will hold it over our own heads.
You literally tape it to every single one of our heads, and we can't untape it.
You have full permission to never let us hear the end of it. I would expect nothing less.
Seriously, thank you all so much for the lovely season, and I would love to see you again next season.
Yep.
We cannot thank wait. You.
It's gonna be crazy, because obviously we have to wait till the new stuff.
And then that's obviously gonna dictate things, so.
See you,
Sensei. Anyway.
That is possibly younger than me, but I refuse to accept that reality. Moving on. Most despised mon. We're not giving an award for this one, are we, technically? Isn't this the one where we don't technically give an award out because you don't want this one?
No, I think this one... I mean, I feel like it's award-worthy, but at the same time, I feel like it's one of those...
It's like the joke award. It's like the joke award.
It's the joke award. I think it counts... It counts, but at the same time, it's definitely not the one you want to have.
Yeah, so Buzzwole won this last season, because no one liked that Buzzwole. So this we amassed another list. At one point, we had every single team had a mon that was most despised. Then we kind of cut the list down considerably and then gave some teams two to try and fill the list back up with only the mons that were seriously despised by a vast number of people. So we're going to start with Mega Mawile. No one really likes playing against a Mega Mawile. That Celesteela trying to sweep everyone, a little bit annoying. It's also just a Celesteela. It was bulky as shit. We don't talk about this fucking Corsola. Goddamn. Ended with 5 passive deaths. only was there for half the season and holds the record for most all-time passive deaths by 2. I don't know how that happened. Urshifu, I mean, it was also only within like the last 5 or 6 weeks of the season, but, you know, embarrassing the shit out of me. Like I was saying earlier, I looked back at my footage from last season. Urshifu could have had like 15 kills last season. He just didn't secure a lot of them. He did like 70% to a bunch of shit, but then just didn't finish them. So I didn't use him that badly. Okay. Mega Aggron, Jack used it. It was kind of annoying and bulky as shit. Clef, the baton passing and the boosting. It's a Clef. People are not going to like it. Yeah, it's Reggie. We don't talk about that, Reggie Steele. Fuck you. I could have saved you all. That's all I'm going to say. I could have saved you all. Mega Diancie. And Mr. Mime. We didn't put Gudra on there, or like Milo.
I don't think Gudra was at the spies, though. It was just... Yeah,
it is just annoying. But the winner, in air quotes, of most despised Mon is, of course, this fucking Reggie Steele. So, Tyler, congrats, question mark.
Maybe.
I mean, Zygar 10%, I think it was just because it only pissed, like, 2 people off that we didn't put it on there, Kevin.
Yeah.
So, yeah, Tyler, congrats in air quotes. You can gain permission to speak. Again, I could have saved you all from the true wrath of the Iron Taco. I still want to kind of draft it next season now. Because I got blue-balled this season from having Reggie Steele, so...
Hulk gave you so many tacos. He just said, here, hold this.
Real quick about this. This is now the second Mon that has gotten 2 awards.
That is true.
In specific.
Mm-hmm.
My head only got 2, and then this has gotten 2. For the Salty's exact game. Opposite reasons.
Yep.
I want it to be known, by the way. This wasn't even close.
No.
Reggie Steele ran away with it. The runner-up, Reggie Steele got 10 votes.
10
so
out
again,
of the
13 just
eligible
like,
votes.
Yeah. The runner-up was Urshifu, and it only got 7.
Yeah, it won by 3 votes.
Like, everyone else, the next rung down from that was Clefable with 4. Reggie Steele ran away with this.
Mm-hmm.
I will say this. My original plan was not to make this thing the most hated thing on the planet. I just needed a defensive Mon to work out the core that I came up with on the fly. But after the second sweep, I started thinking, you know what? It's time to instill some existential dread. I'm just going to bring it, cause chaos, and then it's going to disappear for 4 weeks, and people are going to wonder where it went.
Well, mission accomplished.
That was the plan by the end. I guess maybe I am the villain of this season after all.
I guess I'm still sad at the beginning of the season. I was so adamant for you to call it the Iron Taco to continue its legacy. And now the Iron Taco's name has been etched into the stones of hell.
You have no one but yourself to blame, Wade.
I know, it's sad. True. The Iron Taco is now forever in vain.
It has encapsulated the entire season in its steel shell of despair.
So that means next season is going to be the dawn of the aluminum burrito, right?
No, I think
that was
just
one of them.
I think I'm just going to keep them shiny and call them purified taco. I think is the plan.
My favorite is still steel chimichanga.
I still think titanium burrito has a shot.
And don't forget mercury chalupa.
Well, oh, don't even get me started about nickel quesadilla.
You could take the fucking Crunchwrap Supreme elsewhere. We're going to move on. Okay.
I'll be back. Moving on.
To Kalisto. He's also not here. But newcomer this season finished 5th place overall in the regular season. Basically, I wouldn't say impressed all of us. I think all of us expected him to do well. Just we didn't know what that was
going to entail because he could have done really well at stall.
He could have. He just played very solid balanced offense.
Just balance. Yeah. Balanced.
And
also abused baton passing to its fat loss.
I mean, that's why we banned it on tier ones last season for the exact reason.
I still don't think that was the right call to even begin with because, like, that's still, like, super
don't know.
Well, now we know Baton Pass will just be non-existent next season.
It'll be Dry Pass next season.
Yeah. Lion Boy's remark was first season and got fifth. Good job.
Yeah. What was your
question? Only thing I have to say really about this is...
The question was honestly, how much did he enjoy the league? Because, you know, as the newcomer...
He seemed like he really liked it because of the message he put in.
He didn't send that one message, so...
Yeah. Because it's just, as the newcomer, I was very interested to see, you know... Really, I like to make sure everybody's having fun. That's what I care about.
He was also just, like, a pure newcomer. Because, like, other people
literally pure, like,
were already in the
disconnected,
server.
Disconnected. Not
straight
from
up
anyone.
Just, like, joined the server. He's like, yo, what's good? Someone said there was a draft league. I would just want to see.
Yeah.
Well, no, Tyler posted our league in the... recruitment thing and he joined up.
Mm-hmm.
Tyler, did you post it in the sports server or did you post it in the Jambad server? Because I know you're in both.
I don't know which one you did.
I don't know which one you put it in.
Oh, I will. Okay, one thing I will.
He's in neither.
Yeah, so it was a different server. Regardless, only thing I really have to say at this point about it is I apologize for the flinches. It would have been a really close game otherwise. The power whip on Jealous thing, that was 100% right on me. It was just the two flinches afterwards that made it.
Yeah, I mean, my game with him was way more close than it should have been, again, because I've been going through every single one of my videos to, you know, find all the despair. I misplayed the first, like, five turns against him. I was yelling at my computer. I'm like, what the fuck am I doing? Like, what am I doing? Why? Why would I assume that? What am I thinking? That was basically, like, half the games. I was just yelling at my computer. I'm like, what am I doing? That's such a bad idea. That's so risky. And, yeah. I lost my fucking Rillaboom the second turn because I thought Delphox was scarfed when he never brought scarfed Delphox all season. I'm like, yeah, Delphox is scarfed. Yeah, it's just probably scarfed. I have no proof, but it probably is. Switch my Rillaboom into a fire type and just fucking dies. Because, you know, I'm smart. I deserve to finish in fucking 10th if I was playing like that. Goddamn. It was not good. But we'll see how he does in playoffs. And I think did embrace the jankiness of the league. I didn't know if he was going to, or if he was gonna like not like it with how janky it is, but he definitely embraced it. So I hope he comes back for next season.
Alright, moving right along. This is gonna be the last one I commentate, but gotcha. I have to do this one because this is the one where I point out the little factoid that's gonna be hilarious.
Yes. Best nickname. This is one of my favorite categories because we don't list the mons. We only list the nicknames.
We don't list the mons because as I agree, and I agree with the philosophy. The philosophy is that if the nickname truly is the next best nickname, it will stand independently of the mon.
Yeah.
You should be able to associate it with the mon without even knowing which mon it is.
So and we do have them in order through the team.
We do have them in order. There were two nominations for each team.
Yep.
So, and these were submitted by the team owners themselves. Of course, we have... It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno.
It's not delivery.
We then have regret.
Report regret.
We have Petch.
Petch and Daffy, I think it was.
And Daffy for the Florida Farfetch. For the Canberra Cacturns, we have Fling the Poop and RKO. For Moonlit Masquerade, we have Dryerlint and the Ex-Wife. For the Bronx Blaziskans, we have Pepsi Max. Thank you, Spooks. And the Iron Mantis. For the New Amsterdam Arachnids, we have Saitama and Max Ammo. For the Boston Bidoofs, we have Average Chihuahua and Fortified Brush.
This name's just so weird.
For the Carolina Mews, we have Clarissa and Spooks' Will. Batarang. For the Regal Resonance team, we have Spooks' Will and Pokechin MD. For the Brooklyn Baynets, we made the nicknames for him. He never nicknamed his own Moz, disclaimer. We have Dion Ooh and Treesus. For the Copenhagen Ferrets team, we have Golden Gun and Metro 2 Moogaloo. For the Quick Claw Strays, we have Fat Miramon and JP Shibayama.
The dynamic duo.
For Full Metal Alchemies, Sensual Moaning, you're welcome, Tyler. And Wolf Size Large. And for the McAllen Morpicos, we have Fetish Bait and Doing Your Mom.
Doing Your Mom.
Now, before I reveal the winner, I would like it to be known that at one point, there was a clear tie between Spooks' Will and someone's ex-wife. Take that as you will. But without further ado, our winner is Spooks' Will. Congratulations, Sandy.
The lore behind this name is
just so good.
Beautiful. And he didn't even keep the Don fan all season. But he named it this basically every single time he brought it. And
it just stuck. It just stuck.
It stuck in people's heads.
Okay, I'm gonna need to say this. I need to get Spooks in here because I want him to say it because it feels like it's only right because it's his bit that he needs to actually say what this involves.
If we had more time or if I had more patience, I would have attempted to like edit Ashes and like disheveled children.
You could have asked me.
I still just think it's hilarious that at one point there was a direct tie between Spooks' Will and an ex-wife.
All right. So the entire bit is that when I die, I want my ashes to be put into an elephant cannon, and whoever collects the most gets the will. Sandy was really hungry for my will this season. He's looking to get in.
He wants that 401k, man.
See, the funny thing is...
He's looking to become my widower.
See, the funny thing is...
Sandy, are you free on Friday for a date?
3-foot trunk.
We get a ticket to Texas after I go to Hoboken.
Wait, Spooks, are you admitting to cheating on Tyler live on stream?
I was really hoping Tyler raised his hand to join the call.
No, he said, why are you cheating on me?
Spooks is a cheater? Gone wrong?
After our stalled
more news
date,
at 11?
You guys basically did go to the movies together.
Oh my god. Spooks, you fucking unloyal bastard.
You and Snazzy were fucking cuddling in the top left corner. You're like, this is such a good movie.
Oh my god. The National Enquirer is going to have a field day with this one.
Oh my god.
Oh.
Wait, I need the vacuum power up from Ballad Wonderworld.
We had a connection.
Oh my god.
Bro, I actually, like, someone brought up Elephone Cannon to another server, and I mentioned that, one of my friends wants to actually blow his ashes out. Oh, hold on.
Spooks, you and I need to have a talk.
Don't worry, I got the perfect thing. It's called counseling.
It's not you, it's me.
But yeah, the funniest thing is that at one point someone mentioned the elephant cannons. I'm like, yeah, one of my friends wants to shoot his ashes out of one of those. Whoever collects the most gets the will. And everyone was like, how would you collect ashes with a butterfly net? And then someone said, you use your lungs.
No, you just you fill the butterfly net with a layer of Flex Seal first.
Yeah, you don't actually like use the butterfly net.
Well, no, because if you put a layer of Flex Seal at the bottom, then that means all the holes are going to be filled up. So that means it'll actually hold the ashes.
And then we get Phil Swift involved.
I don't know how you would count those.
Okay, also, I wanted to be known that Kevin said in chat, bruh, if going to a movie equals a date, then I'm a fucking 30-time cheater.
Atta boy, Kevin! Okay, moving on. The fucking play.
Yeah, this is mine. That's actually... Different. Hold on, I want to say some things first. Oh wait, no, you had the go, didn't you say?
No, I said that was the last category. I personally felt the need to commentate. I don't care who says the last one now.
That was not my logo at the beginning. I got a little bit of a cocky, and I made my meal mob boss.
You come to me
On the day of my haunt's wedding.
And the haunter is a minion. And then, that's one. I just like how I was able to do it, so
I'm happy with it. I'm going to the movies equals a date that I'm still as single as I was before.
It's amazing that I made this team work as well as I made it. Like, it has no right to work this way.
Oh my god.
Amoongus, Nidoqueen, Salazzle, Golbat. Like, literally even ate a hunter to her. Literally even after all my transactions. I still have, like, half mono poison. And it's really hard to juggle that, if I'm gonna be honest. Especially when you only have, certain types on
and
things
have,
like Amoongus.
And you have two water types. And two psychic
yeah,
types.
Though I was not expecting the trades, for Mega Slowbro when I picked up Gyarados, because that happened 2 weeks before.
Yeah.
I needed Gyarados so that way I could have a water type period at that point. The fact that I have two now is just kind of unfortunate, but...
Alright, so Lion Boy's remark for Clay was,
oh boy,
had some surprises in the team that I was not expecting. My question for Clay is actually pretty interesting one, I think.
From you or Lion?
For you. This is my question for you.
Okay.
If you had to take any one of your non-poison types and make it poison type so that you could draft it again in a potential monotype next season, which one would it be and why?
Would it just, like, add the typing to it, or
replace one of the typings if you're choosing if it's a dual type? Otherwise, if it's
him
one
only.
Type only, add it.
Him only. Easy.
Poison fighting.
Can stab poison jab for the fairies.
That would be nice.
Plus fairy resistance, too.
I mean, I talked about my game against Clay earlier. I mean, we were both playing well. It was a pretty solid game, and then I just let the Jirachi come in. And I was like,
well, I kept teetering.
Yeah.
I was just waiting to get Jirachi in on something I could set up on.
Yeah, I was like, oh, poop. And that's why I stopped bringing Mudsdale. That was the last week I brought Mudsdale all season, because every single time I brought Mudsdale, I got swept. Because Mudsdale just gets set up on. You could set up on Mudsdale so fucking easily. So I was like, you know what? How about I just don't anymore? And I didn't get swept anymore when I stopped bringing Mudsdale, so...
Actually, okay, no, I started, just real quick, I realized that probably is not a good thing because it's quad 4 week to psychic. So that wouldn't be beneficial.
Hashtag worst toxic rogue.
Yeah, also because it doesn't get a gunk shot or any of the other good poison stuff.
It would just be worst toxic.
What primary type is Hydreigon?
I think it's primary...
Dark.
Is primary dark?
Secondary yeah, it's dragon. Dark dragon in that order.
Dark poison with levitate. You don't even have to change the moveset to make
that's
it...
actually nasty.
You don't even have to change the moveset to make it work.
We already know dark poison is a terrifyingly good type combination.
You
get that levitate, oh my god.
You just need dark pulse, nasty plot, and that's about it.
Yeah, I wouldn't even need to like have my moveset redone without the dragon moves. I could care less at that point.
That's dragon dance, he's still, yeah.
So yeah, that's my final answer. I'm locking that in. Hydreigon replacing dragon.
Yeah. I think we're reaching the point where we're getting tired, so we're just going to start moving on.
Yep.
I mean, and we're also getting to the point where we're already talking about people enough early on in the stream, so by the time we get to them, we're like, we already said basically all we were going to say about this person, so we just kind of...
At this point, I just have my question, my boy's remark, and then that's all I have to contribute. Yeah.
That was just my team, so I had things to say.
Yep. All right, moving on.
I can read that from.
We now have the biggest letdown.
There's some really interesting ones here.
Fucking Ice Age font looking ass.
I mean, it's really good, but I will say, I didn't get to say this to you, Wade, because you did it when you were off call, but the gif that you picked...
For this,
where do you find these things?
Dude, absolutely hysterical.
Some of the ones I found later on too. The SVP one also. All I put was the Mon's name and then GIF, and then just scrolled one of the first really few far down. There's
no way that is all you put into Google.
Yep, that's all I put into Google.
Look it up while I'm going down the list. Look it up while I'm going down the list.
Really far down until I found it.
Start things off as big as letdown. We have Mega Beedrill.
Yeah, that is very true.
It was supposed to be his saving grace as his Mega, and it
got less kills than my floor just when the season ended.
Nigga Lego for Ray. It did not do nearly enough as what the mon was supposed to do.
Again, to be fair, Mega Beedrill did heavily chunk a lot of things and then just...
Yeah, but it didn't do anything that substantial or sweep. It just kind of was there. That's not what you wanted in a Mega Beedrill. Especially since that's your Mega slot.
Can't say
Swampuff for Lion Boy. Because he
all his tier was in tier twos were doing things, so it was a little different.
Jolteon.
Oh my god, it's actually there.
Yep.
Jolteon from Hylian's End. We also then have Rotom Wash that didn't do nearly enough. Mandibuzz from Yarune. Then Tapu Bulu from Jek. Moongus from me. Dwebble from Sandy because we had to we couldn't actually make any of his other mons.
He didn't bring Suicune enough to say it was a letdown.
Yeah, Flygon from Cleisto, Dragapult from Sev.
Fuck that Dragapult.
Hoop Unbound from Kevin.
He did fucking Hoop.
Shut up. Conkeldurr from Fulvera Alchemies, and then Mega Slowbro when he had it, when Spooks had it. I don't think you guys are ready for this gift, to be honest.
And the winner is...
This gift is...
The winner is this ridiculous fucking Roblox gift.
That is a... that's a gift and a half, I have to say.
It's just so...
Why does it look like it's... It looks like it's a Super Saiyan.
It's supposed to be a fucking JoJo's character. I can't breathe.
It's hello? Just so good.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I want to say something, but I'd rather revoke my right for speech.
I only have these gifts. I only had to find gifts for things that were Gen 5 and past because I don't have a normal non-shiny sprite for them on my computer. Because of the way those HD sprites got laid out for some reason, Gens 1 through 4 are non-shiny and Gens 5 through 7 are for some fucking reason. So... Poopa is... I didn't want Hoopa to be all gold and just sitting there, because that's weird looking, and I didn't want to go find a not HD sprite. So I'm like, okay, let me go find a GIF of Hoopa Unbound. And then I saw this, and I'm like, we're using this.
Can't confirm, he literally just typed in Hoopa Unbound GIF into Google. It was there. It showed up.
It's just so magical. We probably need to move on before we get stuck on this.
I mean, also just Hoopa...
I could stare at the GIF all day.
Hoopa got comically killed twice. It didn't get a kill all season. This is the second time Kevin's used it, and it's the second time it's done nothing.
Kevin, stop leading this thing in against bug types, please, for the love of God.
Or just run it max attack, max speed.
Or just, do that instead of trying to make it...
Stop trying to make it bulky. We've done the calcs. This thing dies from full when it is max HP, max defense to a skill smack from a fucking Weedle.
It did only one thing season one, and that was like seal the deal against Wade.
Yep.
But
ever since.
And now it is getting locked up forever.
Yeah.
Well, Spooks is gonna draft it. We already bet on that. Cash money. And
please, can we commission Spooks' gift to be auto-locked at least for League 1?
Mm.
If it gets on MVP table season 4, like, please.
Please. It has to be this.
Please. That is just so...
Oh, wait, no, Kevin, who are you thanking?
Oh, yeah. First of all, every time I was actually against a bug type, every time I had Tankerberry, they didn't bring bug moves at all. And when I didn't bring Tankerberry, or tried something else, I brought bug moves. But I am going to be thanking... I'm going to be thanking the Queen of Denmark. She's just such a lad.
Wait, Denmark's a monarchy?
Yeah.
Did not actually know that.
I didn't. Well, either. It's just purely like a title now, right?
It's just an honorary status, okay.
Yeah, yeah, and she has to, approve the laws that get passed in the parliament.
Okay, so it's the same thing as like UK, royal family.
Yeah,
exactly.
Right? But I have to thank her. Little known fact, she is my dad's father-in-law is actually in a quote-unquote gang with the queen.
Oh. Is that something you should be disclosing on the internet?
I don't know how I feel about the royal monarch being in a street gang.
Watch yourselves.
Fun fact, she is actually ranked Plat in Valorant. thought these were going to say something like that. She's actually fucking Diamond in Rocket League. She's pretty fucking cracked.
Oh, she yeah. is she is actually a tough leaderboard in League of Legends. Watch yourselves. And I'm out.
Moving on to Lion Boy.
Staying here in the Netherlands, huh? Learned something today. So, Lion Boy did actually make a remark for himself. Wade's gonna get a kick out of this one. Four words only. Did not do stall.
No, he didn't. To be fair, he did not. A little bit different. He did play differently than he did last season. He transitioned from very bulky offense, borderline stall, to balanced offense. Which is, the smart thing to play in draft. I don't know what fucking dumbass would draft hyper offense every single season and expect it to work in draft when everyone's drafting balanced.
I'm standing right
offense.
Here.
So, I was about to say, it feels like you're calling someone out.
I'm calling myself out.
Also, to be fair, I didn't really. This is like the first season I've actually.
This is the third season I've
objectively
done.
Hyper offense.
And if any season was the most balanced for me, it was last season, and last season's the season I did the best. So maybe I should start taking hints.
If anything, I brought bulky offense the last two seasons.
If anyone is going to date me, they should have to watch my entire every single HDL replay to show how well how good I am at taking hints and how good of a listener I am.
you definitely it's right did there. Not. He did. Hey, Wade, want to see a movie? Don't you dare!
No.
Don't do it!
No, I
do not. Honestly, no, he definitely did not bring Stahl. Hell, even Celesteela, objectively, like, the Stahliest, quote-unquote, Mon. Yeah. Yeah, he never even really ran Stahl.
Against Spooks, but that was part of the...
He had, like, the whole Weakness Policy Atomize set, but, like, it's not even Stahl-y.
It's just a good set.
He didn't Stahl. It's just a good set.
I'm hydrating again. Okay, back to Lion Boy. So that Ndidi thing, Ndidi might have been the league MVP if he had it all season. Not gonna lie, because it got 9 kills in 4 weeks.
Also, just did a lot.
Yeah, it was just fucking crazy. Like it just fucking showed up, got 9 kills in 4 weeks.
It's Jeff. Thanks to Lion Boy, that is absolutely getting a bump up on the tier list next season.
You were pretty good at that dance, not gonna lie. Yep, that's my secret talent. I'm just good at Fortnite.
I don't know how to feel about that.
Lion Boy finished third. A little bit. I mean, Jack not showing up kind of helped. It just gave him a free win. So Lion Boy basically had two buys instead of one, which is, I guess it's a little bit of a blessing.
Can we get a Fortnite belly dance? That's a thing!
I don't know how to belly dance. I don't know if that's saddening to any of you, but I don't really know how to belly dance. Lion Boy finished third. He did finish second last season. So of the last two seasons, he finished second overall regular season and third overall regular season. So this man just knows how to just play pretty solidly in the regular season. His prep is usually pretty solid. Usually puts a lot of effort into his sets and researching. The one thing I'm going to say about Lion Boy, no one can't fap to Steamer of subscribe. Oh no. Oh my fuck.
I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die.
Can't fap to Steamer.
I'm gonna die.
I'm gonna go into Pokimane's chat and type send show feet, please. OMG, she show feet, Lamel.
Spooks, just go online and watch yourself.
Okay. Back to what I was saying. I don't think there's anyone here that is as good at predicting what the other person is going to bring as Lion Boy is. Or at least the one couple times I've played him, or the times I've heard him talk about playing other people. I don't know how much of it he's bullshitting, but most of the time, what he guesses that people are going to bring, they bring that exact fucking thing. He knew I brought Smackdown on my Mudsdale for his Celesteela.
It's actually terrifying how good his intuition is.
No one in their right mind would assume I had Smackdown on my Mudsdale against a Celesteela. Unless someone told it, because I'm pretty sure I told a bunch of people about that set. So unless someone told him about it and he knew, but he was like, yeah.
I didn't even talk to him at all that week.
He's like, yeah, I figured you had Smackdown on it, with just the way you were using it. Or like, that would be something that would be smart to bring against my Celesteela. I'm like, what? Like, how the fuck did you know? Like, what? So that, like, scared me. Like, he knows what people are going to bring. And I think that's what helps him succeed so well in the regular season, just play so solidly. Because this man does not get swept. His games are always solid. Like, always. So it's like, I don't know. Just claps around. Ask Lion Boy about Surf Garchomp. He does not like Surf Garchomp. I know that. But moving on. We're now on to, in my opinion, this is my favorite award, the unspoken MVP. It's a little hectic when with people typing in their own thing because, you know, that's the whole point of the award. It can't be unspoken if we're giving you options because then it would be spoken. So it's like, you know, there's no point. So I like sifting through all the things people say. What I don't like doing is saying, hey, you fucked up. You can't nominate that mod. Which one do you want to nominate instead? Having a random-ass note list on the side. That gets a little hectic. But I want to preserve this award as much as we can because this is one of my favorite awards. It's one of those mods that people, like, they just respect. Even though it hasn't done much, it's something that has put in a lot of work and just gained respect.
I can't take you seriously. We can chat as in the state it's in. I'm sorry.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh.
Smart and good. He's very much underrated. Yeah. Smackdown is fun. Call 696-96 to get your steamer today. 1-800-STEAMER. Stanley Steamer is your dick cleaner. Fantastic. Back to unspoken MVP. This list, or this week, this almost went to a tiebreaker. And I didn't know how we were going to handle the tiebreaker. But Jack actually broke the tie. Jack nominated Yarun Skuntank in one of his three votes, which was not valid. So I DM'd him asking.
Number didn't work. Scam.
This is not a PG stream, Kevin. Have you listened to me talk on any of my streams?
I would like it to be known that you probably didn't catch it up because you're not having Discord. As soon as you finished the Snazzy's comment on Stanley Steamer, Jack joined the channel.
Oh. He's been summoned. Jack, you won most improved. Again. I think that's it, though. We're on unspoken MVP now. I think that's all you won. That's all Jack won, right, so far?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, you won most improved again. And you could just, I guess, go back in the VOD to when you see, like, your slide up for us talking about you, because we passed your team thing. My season has been very unremarkable. You want to fight immediately after? I don't know if he has his team built. But, yeah. So, Jack, I was just starting talking about you because he unbroke... Oh, he does. Oh, okay. So, he unbroke the tie because... Here's what I'm going to say. There was a mon with three votes. It ended up being the mon that won. Then there were two other mons with two votes. One of them was my Florges. Another one was Clay's Jirachi. Mr. Mime also had three votes. And then this mon had three votes. So I'm like, Jack could say a bunch of mons here and it could send us to like a 3-mon tiebreaker. But then he said this mon, so therefore, this mon ended up winning. Therefore, long Zero Aura is going to come in. And the winner of Unspoken MVP is...
Damn, my massive forearm is stuck in a can of sour cream and onion Pringles.
It was
please,
original Pringles,
send help.
Yes, Jellicent of the Brooklyn Bay Nets is Season 3's Unspoken MVP. He actually didn't bring Jellicent to a lot of games, but when it was there, it was putting in a lot of work. I think this is another thing of, like, I'm one of the only people that dispatched the Unspoken MVP, or, like, one of, like, the front runners for Unspoken MVP quickly, because I remember I, like, O-code it with Brave Bird or something stupid. But, like, any other person that played the Jellicent, like, I remember watching, it would just get Will-O-Wisps off for free. You crunch it on a read turn one. I think it was just me and you, but then the other, like, four times he brought it or whatever, it was doing really well, and his win percentage with it was really good, and people obviously noticed that this thing was just putting in a lot of work when it needed to. Again, like I said, my floor just got a decent amount, or got like 2 votes. My Rotom got like 2 votes. Mr. Mime got 3 votes. I can't remember anything else that got multiple votes. I'd have to look through the thing, and people formatted things differently. But those were the ones that I can remember off the top of my head. That got votes like that. So, Jellicent wins Unspoken MVP for this season. I guess, hopefully, next season, Unspoken MVP, we can also match a food to, because last season was Del Monte, so we were able to put, you know, corn behind him.
Come down today and try some corn, or we will sacrifice your newborn.
And we obviously are going to put Pringles next to a Jellicent, so, yeah, that's how it be. So, moving on, we're going to go to Sandy now. If you guys haven't been noticing, every single time there's a team change, I changed the light color to, you know, the colors to match their team, because...
You fuckers, that wasn't a sour cream and onion Pringles, that was original, I hate you.
Yeah, I know. I realized it the second it came up, I'm like, wait, that should be sour cream and onion. But yep, Sandy, second overall, the 2 seed going into the playoffs.
So,
have you won a playoff game before, Sandy?
Yes.
I think he made it to semis.
Did you make the semis last season? Because I remember season one.
I think.
I can actually check this real quick. Give me a second.
I think I made semis first season.
You lost to Clay first round, first season.
No, he lost against Clay season two.
It was both times. I forgot the same thing happened.
And then season one...
It was Clay again.
I'm going to double check anyway because you have a curious. Let's see here. Playoff jacket. Yep, sure enough. Both seasons. He lost to Clay playoffs.
Yeah.
Immediately.
And then he already beat Seth, so...
And now I can lose to him in semi.
Good.
So, real quick, I've actually been waiting. So, I've been waiting to bring this one up because this has been, I don't know what the hell Lion Boy means by this comment. It's been in the back of my head for the past 3 days. I've spent literally 3 days trying to decipher its meaning, and I've got nothing. So maybe Sandy can understand it because I don't. Lion Boy's remark is that Dwebble Moster.
Monster. He means monster. He just spelled it. He spelled it like cheese. It sounds like he spelled it like cheese, but he fell down the stairs.
He spelled it M-O-S-T-E-R. And for the life of me, for the past 3 days, I've been trying to figure out whether or not he meant monster or if he somehow tried to type must die.
No, he meant monster. He just missed the end.
Or he meant moss.
Yeah,
moss is pretty tasty.
But yeah, that Dwebble.
Aha.
Yeah.
So, the question I've got for you, Sandy. Way back at the beginning of this season, you weren't going to be the Regal Residence, and you know what? I have to know, what the fuck were you going to be called at the beginning of this?
So, actually, you didn't change it, and I didn't comment on it. The original plan was to change myself to the Unforgettable Luncheon and use that image, but you didn't do it.
You never told me.
I actively said literally the day before I fought Wade, you're not fighting the Regal Resonance, you're fighting the Unforgettable Luncheon. And I posted the image, and nobody commented on the fact that I was changing my image to that.
Because I don't think we did name changes mid-season.
So I'm not going to lie, the reason I didn't do it was because I couldn't tell whether or not you were being serious. I thought it was a bit.
Yeah, I thought it was a bit.
Oh, of course you were being serious. Well, actually, you know what? It being new, that makes sense. Yes. I mean, I'm currently a thumb, so that does make sense.
He's currently a thumb.
He's currently a
thumb. I'm a very opposable person.
Yeah, it's just... Yeah, I've killed 3 of Sandy's Mons all time in 3 games.
No, it was 4, I think.
No, it's 3. Because I got 6-0'd, you 4-0'd me Season 1, you 5-0'd me Season 2, and then you 6-0'd me Season 3. So... I don't know how the fuck you're going to 7-0 me Season 4, but I'll figure out a way.
I'll 7-0 you by reviving one of my Pokemon.
He's got a Lunar Dance or something. He's going to, like, find a way. He's going to find a way to just, like, take him out that was on the verge of death.
That's the
like
one thing I'm glad Pokemon's never done, is made a move where you can revive a team member.
I mean, I'm honestly surprised they haven't basically made a variant of Lunar Dance where it's, like, X Pokemon dies, and then...
I feel like it'd be a charge move. Like, it's a two-turn move.
I think it would just be, like, you sacrifice one Pokemon to bring another Pokemon back at, like, half health or something. Or maybe it comes back with the amount of health that the Mon you sacrificed had.
And then they give it to a bulky Mon, and then you could just... Then stall teams become infinitely more scary.
So, like, say, Cresselia's at half health, uses the move, right? And then whatever the hell the HP Cresselia was at... That's the amount of HP the Mon that revive
giving
has.
Giving it to Cress is like the worst idea ever.
Well, I'm saying theoretically.
Yeah.
I'm not saying give it to Cress. I was just the first thing that came to my head because Lunar Dance.
Well, Sandy, I actually have a question for you, Sandy. Will Zeraora, Suicune, Decidueye, and or Cinderace be making another reappearance next season?
I'm taking that Zeraora.
If you fuckers let me have it again, yes.
I'm taking that Zeraora.
If legit, if people leave it around long enough, I will take it. I will take every single, at least one of those Pokemon if someone leaves it for me.
I think Cinderace is now the only Mon that someone has used 3 seasons in a row.
I have had plans for that Zeraora since Season 2. I'm taking the Zeraora, and you can't stop me. No one can stop me.
Unless I get Round 1 pick and be the first person to make a serious Round 1 pick and take Zeraora so you can't.
There is exactly one way people can stop me.
Yeah, if he gets a first overall pick again, he could just take Zeraora and be like, Kylie can't have it now.
Please do not be the one to stop me.
Yeah, no, no, I will. I know you want it, I'm going to take it. But for real, though, letting me have Cinderace 3 seasons in a row in the points round, I still don't understand how that ended up happening. Even Season 1, it was just Blaze, but it's still Cinderace. It still went into points. It's like... one of the best Mons currently in draft. And then we changed it to Libero. And then I got a first round of points.
Yep.
And then this season also got a first round of points. I still don't understand how I've managed this.
The question for you was originally going to be, by the way, Sandy, of when are you finally going to bring Electrowile Cinderace? But then you actually did it. So
oh,
I
no,
can't...
I did that in Season 2 already.
I did in Season 2.
You actually doing Season 2, I forgot.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Yeah,
this,
I ran
that was the sweeper, that was this cleanup, sweep, Cinderace.
Huh.
It was versus Jack when I said GG's, but, when I got the double protect.
Hey, Game Freak, please never give Cinderace Wild Charge.
Please make it Electric type.
It should have been Fire Electric.
Should have been.
Anyways.
Yeah. Unless you have any thoughts on how your season went. Or, I mean, you're already in semis, so.
This season went probably one of the best seasons I've ever done. I have 3 losses, and I believe all 3 of them were only 1-0s.
They were.
Yeah, so this is probably the best I've been done in a league in terms of standings and win-loss ratio, and not terms of, like, how well my Pokemon have done themselves. Even if this is chill.
That is true.
Now, excuse me, I gotta go stick my dick in the couch.
Okay,
what?
I'm fine with that. Moving on. We have the SVP, otherwise known as the Surprise Valuable Pokemon. So this is like a tier 4 or a tier 5 or a mega. It's just like, okay, it's one of those mons, like, you just kind of have to pick it. Most people only bring these mons like 3-4 times a season. It's like kind of a niche tech pick. They just bring it. And then some people bring these mons like 9-10 games in the season, and they're a key member of their team, and everyone knows that they have them, and they're basically treating them like a tier 1 or a tier 2. So that's where this award comes in. So first we have, of course, my boy Chevy Chase, the Floatzel. This was also submitted by every single coach. Then we have Gallade from the Florida Farfetch'd. Lion Boy nominated his Indeedee female. From the Moonlight Masquerade is Magnemite. New Amsterdam Arachnids, Yuru nominated his Skuntank. From the Boston Beedus, we have Flareon. Clay nominated his Golbat. From the Regal Residence, we have Medicham. Brooklyn Bayonets, that Delphox. From the Copenhagen Ferds team, we have Mega Steelix, since it is a tier 3 Mega. From the Quick Claw Stray, Sev was debating heavily on which to nominate here, but he ended up going with his Electivire. From the Fullmetal Alchemy, we have Drapion. And from the Metalmor Picos, we had Rapidash. Now, I'm going to say this. Poor Magnemite got 0 votes. I thought it was going to get at least 1, but it got 0. Other than that, I was surprised. I mean, I'm going to reveal the winner. Gesundheit. I will reveal the winner, and then I'll talk about that. I was legitimately surprised. Pleasantly surprised, but a little bit legitimately surprised. But the winner of SVP is Delphox of the Brooklyn Bayonets. I honestly thought Delphox, Gesundheit, was the favorite going into this. I thought this was the favorite. I thought this, Golbat, and like maybe Skuntank were like the three top front runners. But to my surprise and also dismay, Floatzel got 9 votes and Delphox got 10. Floatzel lost this award by a single vote. I was not expecting that many people to vote for Floatzel, seeing as Floatzel only got like 6 kills and it died like 4 times. But, like, Delphox beat it by 1 vote. And they were, like, the 2 front runners. I think something else had, like, 7, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, the flashbacks to Gengar when it got robbed fucking twice. Poor guy. But, yeah, I don't know, Hylian, if you're still looking at the thing. I don't remember what the other highest mons were. I just know Delphox had 10. Floatzel had 9. And
so, for SVP, Delphox had 10.
Yep.
Floatzel was in second with 9. Indeedee was in third with 7.
Yep.
And just behind that with 6 was Golbat.
Yeah. So there were 2 clear front runners there. And I just saw Floatzel's votes going up. I'm like, no. I'm like, don't give me false hope. Like, Delphox is still going to win this. I'm like, please don't make me think Floatzel has a shot at winning this. I'm like, I don't deserve an award after this season. Don't make me think it's going to win. And then Delphox won. I'm like, okay. I'm like, yeah. I'm like, Floatzel, come on. But I was still shocked that people were voting for Floatzel. Because I just wasn't expecting. But Delphox, dude, this thing put in so much work. It fit so perfectly on his team. Like, it was literally the perfect fire type for his team. It was the perfect speed tier that fit within, like, how he was pivoting around. Or if he would pivot to get this thing in. It would always have the perfect move for the certain situation. It was always chipping things, always doing damage, always felt like it was a threat coming in from the back. Because Delphox does have a deceptive amount of speed and packs a deceptive punch. Like, I don't think Delphox should be bumped up to tier 3. I think Delphox is wholly a tier 4 mon.
He's just a really good tier 4.
He's just a really good tier
4. I don't know who was saying that, but that's definitely not the case.
I don't think it's a really good tier 4. I just think he used it so well and it fits so perfectly into this team that, like, it looked so much better. But, like, damn. Like, I thought this was definitely the favorite, and I'm not shocked at all, obviously, that it won this award. Because it put in so much work. Like, this was, like, the main damage dealer. One of the main damage dealers for his team. And we still might see it do even more work in the playoffs. So I guess stay tuned for some more Del Fox shenanigans. Now moving on to the final coaches section for this presentation. We have our first place finisher again, Tyler of the Full Metal Alchemy, also setting a positive differential record with plus 32, being the first to eclipse 30 differential wise in the positive direction. There is literally a 60 kill swing almost between me and Tyler. I don't know how the fuck that happens. I don't know how over the course of a season you get a 60 kill fucking swing, but it's there.
I mean, honestly, I was caught off guard by how this season went. And it's the third season in a row where I've just casually walked into the one seed out of nowhere. And I can't explain it anytime I do it.
I think it's just the way your play style is and how you play bulky offense. When you lose by a small amount. And when you win, it's just someone cannot get through your team. They kill nothing, and then you just beat them like 5-0. That's just how your play style is.
I do have a penchant of breaking things down so that something can just run a team over.
Yeah.
If I had to say anything, it's that my play style is find the weakness and exploit it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the problem is I have to play bulky in order to do that because I need time to find it, you know?
Yeah.
But honestly, considering the only plan I had for draft going into draft day was draft star after funny, haha, I think I did pretty well for myself.
Yeah. I mean, obviously you're the one, so I would say you did pretty well for yourself.
Although, I think I may be the villain now.
Yeah, you are. And I'm not going to sugarcoat it. Yeah. Yes.
I'm sorry, Kevin.
We'll see for playoffs. Jack does get a 1 week run back. I mean, he's running it back right after the stream. So who knows what the fuck is going to happen?
We'll see.
I might even commentate that game live. We could probably do that again. So we'll see what happens.
Indeed.
You do have a title to possibly defend.
I've got my Werther's Original Factory I need to hang on to.
Yeah. So good luck with that. We'll see if you change your team name next season again.
I already did. There is definitely going to be a round 4. If anyone hasn't seen it yet, you will. And it is glorious.
Good luck to whatever that name is or that team next season. We just know you'll be heading it and might end up in first place again. Now, after that, we approach our most...
Whoa! Hold up. I haven't heard Lion Boy's comments yet.
That is true.
Oh, yeah.
With my mouse. And highly so, question.
Lion Boy's comment. Scary, please be gentle.
Scary, please be...
As for my question, will you be gentle?
I don't know. Yarun, are you going to be gentle?
Probably not.
Because I can't be gentle with him if Yarun's not gentle. Then I have to go all out with the guy who... I will say this, me and Yarun, if we play in the semis, we will be the most common matchup in all of HDL history.
I think you already are.
We tie with Sandy Clay.
Oh yeah, I was going to say, if you're not, you're tying with Sandy Clay.
Right, which also means if Clay wins...
Then, yeah.
But considering we've had two finals matches now, I'd say me and Yarun is probably the most hotly contested rivalry, especially since, as of right now, he has a 3-2 lead on me.
That's fair. I mean, you did have to play in the finals twice, so I would say that's a bit of a rivalry.
That, and as we've all learned, Clay is immune to Sandy.
You guys are going to keep saying it until it's not a thing anymore. I don't even think it's a thing.
He's not immune to... He lost to Sandy this season. He's not immune to Sandy.
Well, no. It's a flip-flop. I lose to him in main season.
Yeah.
He beats me main season. I beat him in playoffs.
Yeah. That's how it goes with
me. But I fail. Like, we trade each time.
That's how it is with me and Hylian. Hylian beats my fucking ass. And then when I played him in playoffs, I beat him.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how it is.
Although the first time you won due to freeze hacks.
That is true. Well, now
and
we move.
Now I'm out.
To our most prestigious awards of the season. We're going to begin with most hype Pokemon. Now, this is another one I had managers nominate their own mons. Some were frankly surprising, and after looking at the list after everyone nominated them, the list didn't look how I thought it was going to look. I was like, this list is interesting. But there were people's most favorite mons, and as a season as long as this is, it is difficult for mons to retain hypeness and just be, like, exciting every single fucking week. Kind of, I mean, Arc Result won this last week, and Arc Result was doing something different every single week, so it was always exciting when Arc Result did something. But now Arc Result's done so much, and he has another 13 fucking, or 12 games to do, and it's just, like, the novelty could wear off in a season this long. So MHP was interesting, but people did nominate their own things for their own different reasons, so I will go through them. I nominated my Floatzel, obviously. He finished, what, like four? He would just end up being the last mon for like four games for me. He clutched out two of them, so like, gotta give him the respect. Zapdos for Ray. Celesteela was nominated by Lion Boy for all the different things he was able to do. Snazzy nominated Mega Gardevoir for that one clutch game, and also just applying pressure. Gliscor for Hylian, because, you know, it's that Gliscor. Urshifu single strike for your rune, dropping the boom. Arc Result for Jack, obviously. Nidoqueen for the Carolina Muse. Kyurem for the Regal Resonance. Clefable was nominated by Kalisto. Mega Steelix for the Aethcropid Hanging for its team. Magmortar for Sev, we all saw what that Magmortar's done. Araquanid for Tyler. Zoroark for Spooks. Now, the frontrunners for this award were one was wait. To be expected.
Wait, before you go on this?
Yes.
No, you haven't gone down the nominees yet. Never mind.
I did go down the nominees for this.
Did you?
Yeah.
Oh, you do already click. Okay. Something I noticed when I was formatting everything. Why was Clefable voted for its most hype as well as most hated?
Well, we put it in most hated, and then Kalisto nominated Clefable himself. So, I kind of had to
okay,
put it
that's,
in there.
Actually, yeah, no, that makes sense.
So, I would have... Yeah, so Urshifu
I just noticed the two Clefables are completely different arcing, like,
yeah.
titles.
I would have put Zerkatry for him, but, again, that's just how it is. There was one frontrunner to be expected, and then like two that were like that came in second and third that I did not expect to get as many votes as they did. But without further ado, this season's most hype Pokemon is Fat Marimon, the Magmortar of the Quick Claw Strays. I think this was the favorite looking at that list going into this.
Yeah, definitely.
With the amount of shit that this Magmortar did.
It just...
And the differing shit that this Magmortar did.
He was always changing.
And this has, like, changed the way... I can't look at a Magmortar the same anymore. Like... like... 2 and 3... I think Zoroark came in second, didn't it? I was not expecting to get Zoroark to get as many votes as it did. Zoroark came in second, I'm pretty sure. I think Magmortar won with 10 or 11 votes. Zoroark finished with like 7 or 8. And I forget the third one off the top of my head, but I remember it was another one. I was like, oh, I got a lot of votes. But at the end of the day, Magmortar came out in first place and ended up taking the win. Again, this thing did so many things. It had like four things on luckiest moments. It had like two things on best kill. It just did so much. He brought it to every single game. Sev brought it. This was the first mon to ever reach double digit deaths because he brought it so much. But it was always going in, getting kill, and dying. And Sev is here. Congrats, Sev.
There you go.
I'm here.
You are here. Congrats.
Yeah, the boy. He missed us talking about your team, though.
This is the boy. we compared you to a crazy homeless man on the streets of New York.
Okay, you say we like that when you were the only one with that analogy.
But then you agreed.
Yeah, no. I contested at first because you brought in Brooklyn.
Yeah, okay. I should have just said New York. But yeah, Sev, I compared you to a crazy homeless man on the streets of New York offering to do magic tricks for people. And then this league is saying yes to the crazy homeless man doing the magic trick. And then, like...
Why am I a crazy homeless man? What did I do that was that bad?
It's literally... openly, like, metronoming. Like, just being like, yeah, I'm just going to bring metronome.
I could have worded it better.
And people are staying there being like, you know, okay, yeah, let's do this. And then they lose. So it's just like... You're just accepting the crazy homeless man doing the crazy homeless man thing. And then it's just metronome. Especially on this fucking Magmortar.
People didn't really get much of a choice of what I was doing. Yeah. They could either play with it, or it was still happening.
And then most people that played with it lost when they played with it. So it was just like, wow. And again, the Magmortar commanded games. Like, he had so many times where he would just dictate the outcome of the game.
He was in every single game.
He was in every game. Some of them he wasn't as prevalent as other ones, but in some, he would do something fucking wild, and then the entire momentum of the game would shift. Because...
Either way, though, that's not like a one-sided thing, because let's remember, that thing had a knack for self-deprecation.
I know.
He had a knack for everything.
It made it exciting.
He didn't know what Volt Absorb was. He was suicidal.
But usually his suicidal efforts were productive. At least the Lunar Dance was. I don't remember.
Much like me in middle school, he always wanted his death to come in helpful for someone else.
He's an interesting fella. And interesting has won him the most hyped Pokemon of Season 3. So congrats to Fat Marimon. As we shall proceed to the game of the season, honorable mention. I don't think we took enough time to look at all the games. We kind of slapped this category together at the end and then kind of just threw games into there and threw games into game of the season. I feel like we're going to...
It was definitely needed, though.
It was needed, but we need to have some better refined process for this award because, like... The honor we need to have a more clear-cut differential between honorable mention and actual game of the season. Because it was just like, we didn't know what was going on. We just slapped shit in. But we got an extra category out of it. So we now have the game of the season honorable mention. These were the slightly jankier games or the games with a little bit extra lore or games that didn't finish like close enough but still had theatrical value. So... We now have the game of season honorable mention category. So we had Hylian versus Ray, when both of them were just fucking up consistently. Spooks versus Sev, no skill, only luck. Tyler versus Sandy, nice. A lot of week three games there. Sandy versus Kevin, the quote hypest match so far. Sev versus Sandy, the ultra instinct Grimmsnarl. Spooks versus Lion Boy, when Milotic / Celesteela was annoying. Clay versus Jack, who in Remarkable Lab Tech, but science is never 100%. Just crazy fucking tech going off. The crazy Giga Brain plays. Sev versus Ray, where Serious Sev gave Keanu Reeves a run for his money. Zoeasy versus Sandy. Star Wars 3, Revenge of the Snarl with the reverse Gardevoir Queen, and then Ray and Spooks, where it was just horses. That's it. That was the title. And then Yaroon and Sandy, where it was a gentleman's bout and Sandy's election to change the course of that game. So the winner of the honorable mention of game of the season is... Thank you for it. Quick Claw Strays versus the Regal Resonance, the Ultra Instinct Grimmsnarl. That roll, that ancient power roll, and that Grimmsnarl dodging all those fucking moves. Congrats to you two. That is the honorable mention for game of the season. Again, a little too janky and a little too bullshit for us to move it to the actual category, but nonetheless, probably one of, if not obviously, the most entertaining games of the honorable mention category. That is a big Volt Absorb moment and a big liquidation moment. But yeah. I thought you and Sandy could have had this one too, because again, people just remember the hypest match so far thing. It was like, oh yeah, Volt. But this one, I think this one won close, didn't it? It was like only one vote this one won by. I don't know if...
Give me a second.
Remember, yes. Yeah, this one won by one vote.
It was a three-way tie with four votes.
And then behind this one won by five. This one won with five.
Yep.
What were the games with four votes each? I think one of them was Kevin and Sandy.
There was Kevin and Sandy, Clay and Jack, and then Yaroon and Sandy.
Gotcha. A lot. Sandy had a lot of nominations for this category as well. And then Sandy obviously has nominations for Game of the Season as well. A lot of Sandy's games were entertaining. And as we move on to... It was your first loss. And as we move on to our final category, Game of the Season. Thank you guys for bearing with us for this whole thing. I feel like this went pretty fucking smoothly. I hope the presentation quality was a little bit better than last season as well. Hope the face cam, I guess, helped a little bit in my shirt. I want to let you know, I've been doing this... So bear with me. I want to let you know this shirt that I've been wearing the whole time. It's the first time I've worn this shirt. It still actually has the tag in it. I didn't even take the tag out of the back of the shirt. Will the results get posted? Actually, we could do that. We can share the form to everyone afterwards, I guess, to view.
So you could actually... okay, so... Hylian, well, I learned this and then Hylian did it earlier. You could actually just copy the data.
Okay.
So yeah. I'll make a public power slide presentation of all the different
statistics. We'll copy and paste the statistics and shit. That's actually a good idea, Seth. I didn't even think about doing that.
We're on that right now.
And then, oh, the winners of the awards. We can also post the winners of the awards as well.
Yeah, we can.
So... Why am I actually taking my clothes? I was just proving that the shirt has a fucking tag in it still. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed it. But without further ado, we will get into Game of the Season shortly. Which button goes with this button?
as soon as he figured out how to dress.
I'm not going to do that. Mr. Chunk 2 changing arm wrap. Yeah, you're good. I hope you're feeling better as well. So, week one, Ray vs. Jack, the first down-to-the-wire game. Very close 1-0. Canberra Cacton versus the Regal Residents. There was some real Dwebble hours right there. Sandy again versus Clay. The turns have tabled. Week four of Yaroon versus Lion Boy or Salt Saga 2, the seasoning. Just an entertaining game. Clay versus Spooks, where it was a totally auditory battle. Hylian versus Sev, where the wrath of Gurg was unleashed. Sev versus Kalisto, where JP would like to know where Kalisto's location is. Week 9 of the newest Damn Raccoons versus Mikhail Morpikos, when scarves collided. A lot of scarf action going on and a very close 1-0 game. Lion Boy versus Kalisto, where Lion's expanded dong felt very short of the climax. Almost pulled it out, but was not close enough. Moonlight Masquerade versus the Full Metal Alchemy, where Star Wars 4, a new bathroom happened. Close 1-0 game. Tyler was able to break through the stall. Expanding dong didn't pull out. I said that on purpose. What do you think I was doing? Week 11, Philadelphia Flagon versus the Boston Bruins, where Wade Luck giveth and Wade Luck very much taketh away. Also, week 11, Carolina Muse versus the 8th Copenhagen Ferrets team, where Hitmonlee's Uno reverse card happened. We will see if that solo game can also pull off three awards, all for basically Hitmonlee. And week 12 as well, Philadelphia Flyguns versus the Copenhagen First team. Me and Kevin going for the repeat with the legendary picnic battle. And without further ado, the winner of Game of the Season, thank you, Zeraora, is week 2, the Rigo Resonance versus the Carolina Muse, where the turns have tabled. Now, if you guys do not mind, I will finally take a fucking seat after standing.
I'm actually kind of surprised this one won, to be honest. Especially, so what, there was one... Rocks, yeah.
You can't hear Wade anymore.
Yeah. What?
Three hydrates for that?
Just down it.
Yeah, a 3-0 game, but it wasn't an entertaining game to get
to
that point.
It was entertaining, the skill was there, the sets were there.
Make it five.
End game.
Five, oh my god.
Like, this whole match, like, it felt like either person could win.
At any moment. Really... We even traded the Gyarados sweeps.
It looked like a playoff game in week 2. I remember watching this live.
Yeah,
it looked like a playoff
honestly.
Game.
Honestly.
Like, remember, you set up you had Mega Gyarados still. And you set up with Mega Gyarados, I dealt with your Mega Gyarados, then I set up with my Gyarados.
Yeah. And then, just... Like the beginning, the middle, the end, everything of this match was great. The Medicham lead into the tricking scarf of the Rachi. Yeah. I honestly thought the Rachi was scarf, and I wanted to scarf you... and see if you were scarf, but getting the scarf on you, Medicham coming in and staying in until it died, pretty much, like, just rocked, it rock-tombed the Golbat, it drain-punched the Rachi, it probably could have killed the Muk, but I was predicting the switch into...
Yeah, I know you're predicting the switch, but it was just so perfect.
Golbat again, but Medicham just did its job, stayed in, and then died, it chipped things down, it scarfed Rachi, then... Gyarados came in, wasn't able to do its job very well, but you were able to deal with it itself, and then you were able to get your own Gyarados into sweep. And then
it just never ends.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then just everything about this game was amazing. I didn't think I was gonna win this, but when I got that court change off before you exploded, and then late game when I realized all of your Pokemon died.
All my Pokemon.
I didn't remember that at all. I didn't realize your Pokemon were that low that all of them were died to rocks. But the moment you wished and tried to pass into Hydreigon, I knew.
Yeah, I
won this because
I thought my things were higher up than they were.
Won by a single vote.
Yeah.
Clay and Kevin was actually winning at the beginning, but this gained a lot of votes at the end, and it won by a single
vote. I was about to say the meet Kevin won. We were literally talking about it. I was scared I was going to get three awards. Just from the Hitmonlee.
Yeah.
Because that's what it was looking to be.
Yeah.
From sweep, best game, and One Week Wonder.
There it is. Like, it was close.
I'm glad that isn't the case, though.
Yeah, sorry, Kevin. Kevin almost repeated with Game of the Season. I mean, speaking of that, let's go through, before I play, let's see if anyone besides Kevin, was Kevin the only repeat? Because Salty's match was Tyler and Seth. That was not last season. Salty's match was Yarun, Lion Boy. Spicy's tech was won by Yarun. Kevin won that last season. Most Despised was Tyler. Lion Boy got that last season. Nickname was Sandy. Hylian won that last season. Best Sweep was Clay, which was won by Tyler last season with the Vileplume. Letdown was Kevin. Spooks had that last season with Tapu Fini. Luckiest Moments, a new award. Unspoken MVP, I won that last season. SVP last season was won by Kevin with the Poliwhirl. So, was a repeat with Delphox. MHP, Magmortar won, and Arc Result had it last season, so that's not a repeat. 1 Week Wonder's a new award. Jack repeated with Most Improved. General Manager's a new award. Kevin repeated with Best Kill. And Game of the Season, also not a repeat. So the only two repeats are Jack winning Most Improved and Kevin winning Best Kill. Yeah, you do still hold the current for most awards from the same game because you had Best Kill, Best Tech, and I mean you won Game of the Season off of that. So that...
Wait, no, I think I might have that now.
No, because you got Hitmonlee.
I got Sweep.
I got
1 Week Wonder. I got Game of the Season.
No, you almost did.
Oh, you're talking last season.
Well, no, for this season now.
We're
talking about most awards.
It was me versus Sandy.
We were talking about most awards from the same game is still Kevin. It's what he said in chat.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But this season, I think you technically, in quotes, won the HDL honors. I think you got the most awards. Again, we'll go through it at the end to see who, in air quotes, won HDL honors. But let's go through this replay. So, Clay's going to lead with Jirachi.
Oh, God.
Sandy's going to lead with Medicham. Medicham's going to trick turn one, trick its scarf onto a Jirachi, and gain leftovers. Now, tricking a scarf onto a Jirachi is scary. Already.
Exactly.
I was support, though.
So that was bold. I did not appreciate that. So he's lucky he brought support Jirachi. Rocks already, turn one. So that'll come in handy later for Sandy. Rock Tomb does 32% to an Eviolite Golbat. So that's actually a decent chip there.
Predicted the switch into Golbat because he was stuck in the rocks as well. Yeah. Like, because that was the obvious way.
Yeah, there's no reason for that.
Yeah. Clicks Rock Tomb again because why not? Might as well just get chip value because you know that thing can't heal now. It does have Wish, so you get to see that. Switch into Muk to take this next Drain Punch, but predicts it. Clicks Rock Tomb. This Medicham is already putting in a crazy amount of work just from a lead. Drain Punches again does over half to a Muk. Muk is going to knock it off though, does a lot of damage back, knocks off its leftovers. So now it can only heal with Drain Punch. Rock Tomb is going to slow it down. Did you think he was going to switch there, Sandy?
I thought he was going to go into Golbat because I felt like the Drain Punch was 100% obvious.
Yeah, you had no reason to not Drain Punch there. If it dies, it put in a crazy amount of value.
Yeah, but then Muk didn't do anything outside of me preserving or like that. Yeah. That's why I played it the way I did.
Yep, knocks him off. So Muk actually got 2 kills this week. This is why Muk was a 1 week wonder. Because Cinderace comes in, boots Cinderace, obviously. Clicks court
got
change.
Got them Tims.
Thank fuck he got the court change off, again, as we'll see later. But then, it's gone. So, that's a crazy ass turn.
It was just insanity followed by insanity.
That is hidden, Clay's hidden demise to start here. And then the fucking boom. It's gone. Cinderace is just evaporated.
Well, like, that's how I saw it.
Like, I'm 4-5
I saw it as
now.
Him. Sorry.
Yeah, like, I'm 4-5 now, and that's really scary for me.
Yeah.
When I had a 21 HP Muk against a full HP Cinderace that I'm almost positive is predicting the switch and just core changing or doing any other move, well, I might as well. I get the...
Why
two
the
for
fuck
one.
Not? Worst case, he might have just been, for all you know, he was just U-turning for chip.
Yeah, exactly.
Else.
But even then, that gives me a little bit of momentum because he has to pick something.
And everything left on this team takes a lot from fucking nothing on his team resists an explosion. So now this comes back in on the crypt, and then Jirachi comes back in on this. Wish, because it probably can't kill it in one turn. It's gonna click sub, so Jirachi's gonna heal back up. But it's gonna actually pass it to Golbat. Because it has Infiltrator to get through this sub. It's going to Mega. It's going to click D-Dance, as Clay probably predicted it to do. It's going to get the Wish. Now Infiltrator Golbat is going to get to work. It's going to fucking eat a plus one Waterfall. Like, it's nothing.
Imagine...
That's also because I have, like, no attack investment.
Yeah, he was mostly bulky.
I was bulky to take hits so I could D-Dance a lot behind the sub and then sweep with it.
Yeah. But... Yeah, I mean, even but if you're max, it would probably only do, like, 60.
Now Spooks' will shows his face.
look at the lead.
Immediately, Heart switches back into
put me like in, swivel. Coach!
U-turn.
U-turn. Who wants my couch?
Who wants his couch? Jirachi comes in now. Jirachi's doing a lot of good pivot work. A crit Iron Head. Crit flinch Iron Head?
Yeah, that mattered a lot.
It
mattered. You probably clicked. Did you click? You definitely clicked T-Way that turn.
100%.
Yeah.
Sorry, I forgot. I'm in an elephant cannon.
I'm going to say one thing about this whole season. The worst thing about it is that Spooks Will didn't get to click Scorching Sands.
That's true.
It doesn't get that move, unfortunately, not yet.
Yes.
So the Jumbo Scrimp comes back in. Golbat is going to take even more rocks damage. Jumbo Scrimp's going to D-dance again. Waterfall crits the Golbat. It mattered because we saw it did 35% earlier. So that crit mattered. Golbat's dead. Hydreigon's going to come in now. Also attempt to deal with this. It's just going to start ripping Dracos. It's Life Orb, so this next Draco is going to still do a decent amount of damage and try and finish this Gyarados. This Gyarados has bulk, so it's not going to. This Hydreigon is going to need to fuck off. Clay decides to stay in and go for a U-turn, obviously, because this is Life Orb, so it's still going to... Oh, I'm a dumbass. Hold on. I clicked reset instead of play. Okay.
2 hours later.
He clicks U-turn.
No, I kept... Okay, so the issue was with that. I could not... I had to make sure that he couldn't set up a sub. If he set up sub, then I was even more screwed.
Yeah. But now...
That's why I just kept Dracoing.
Everything on Clay's team is considerably... Or most of the things on his team are considerably chipped. So the rocks come down now. Two sets of rocks are now on the field. Rapidash is going to take rocks damage. Get toxicked by the Salazzle. Not a good look for Rapidash. Hopefully this Rapidash has something to deal with this. It has Protect though, so it's going to...
Yeah, I was about to say, I think the seal, like the whatever... Wait, Clay,
click Substitute. Did okay, you think so, he's going to Protect?
Well, no, I was just... I really thought he was going to switch into... Donphan.
Hmm.
And... The other issue with that is I lost my train of thought.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, you were poisoned already, and if he just hits you...
No, no, I know the poison part. That's not when I was... Oh, I know what I was going to say. I should have just sacked Gyarados there. I should have just, instead of letting it get toxic by switching in Rapidash...
No, but you need Gyarados for Donphan. You don't have anything for Donphan. If you like Gyarados,
Hydreigon does it. It's not that much.
Well, Hydreigon's at 13%, so it just dies to rocks anyway when it comes in.
That's another thing. I thought I was going to do 12%. It did 13.
Yeah.
It might have been at that weird percent where it says it's at 13%, but in reality, it's actually like at 12.
Yeah. Because
percents are like that.
That's actually why I wished the way I did at the very end with the Jirachi.
Baton passes into Gyarados, so now he's not even sacking the Rapidash. Rapidash is just crippled.
I know what it is now. I played Rapidash that way because I didn't see the balloon. Because I had Stomping Tantrum.
Yeah, the Stomping Tantrum was
But I hit. Committed to it, and I was like, oh wait, I can't click a Stomping Tantrum on this. So this thing just checks me because I only had a fire move.
At that point, I would just kept clicking attacking moves on Rapidash until it died, and then just bringing Gyarados and try and click the water.
I don't know if it had another attacking move.
I think I did sub
baton pass with like maybe like.
It was, I think it was six. Morning Sun or Toxic.
It was like yeah, one of the two.
Oh,
I have yes. I still have the team. I can check.
And then. Gyarados is going to go for the Dragon Dance, but he's going to hit with Sludge Bomb again the next turn after, right? Or you're just
going to... No, I outsped it. Also, fun fact, if I didn't get the poison there, I would have won.
Yeah. Because this thing just wins with...
like, that's the thing I about had to go game. For the There's so many there. Ups and
Why
up tides and down tides.
You sacked Swellow so you didn't have to go for the double Protect.
Exactly. Swellow didn't
Yeah, at that point he's just playing the Toxic, yep. Which is entirely what he's supposed to do.
Yep.
Yeah.
Sacking Swellow is a much better play than going for the double protect. The balloon is still in play now. Then you can just click protect again now. So Clay just goes into Jirachi. So now Gyarados will die to rocks when it switches in. He attempts to go for the wish, but then the wish isn't going to mean anything because now every mon just dies.
Yeah. See, you want to know the funniest thing about that? Even if the Hydreigon could kill the...
I didn't outspeed.
Yeah, even if it could kill the... Well, I mean, if it lived for the wish, in like some manner of speaking, the Donphan in the back, it showed up once and it didn't get to do anything. It was rock polish weakness policy.
Oh.
It had player off. It would have killed the Hydreigon.
Well, then...
it was specifically for Hydreigon to rock polish in its face and then kill it with player off.
You don't die to a Draco.
See, no. Sturdy.
You have rocks up.
Sturdy.
Well, I mean, Donphan's in a situation where you didn't have rocks up,
Donphan doesn't get O-code by a Draco meteor.
Oh, Life Orb Draco probably, but if there weren't rocks up, that was the plan.
Yeah. That's why I prioritized rocks as much as I did, because it did a chunk.
Well, it's also how are you killing Salazzle without Draco? I don't know what other moves you had on Hydreigon. You probably had like Dark.
No, I lost it pretty much anyway. The moment that the Sludge Bomb poisoned me, I pretty much lost any chance of winning there.
So you'd have to kill Salazzle away without taking enough damage, and also not Life Orb recoiling yourself to the point where.
Well, and the issue with that is the only thing I have that's faster than Salazzle at that point in the game is my +1 speed Gyarados, and
which is now dead.
In hindsight, I probably shouldn't have preserved it. I should have just like clicked the move and let it die of toxic that way.
Yeah.
And then have a choice Scarf Jirachi. Hope that's what I should have done.
You had a Scarf Jirachi with Iron Head and just.
I was about to say I could have just clicked Iron Head.
Yeah.
Well, no, that wouldn't have done anything to Salazzle. Oh, I had to send a hit, but.
Well, you have to just go for the flinches.
I think my other move is send hit, but if I relieve correctly. No, it was your turn. Never mind. Yeah, I lost it anyway.
Just hope for the flinches. Which is a decent enough.
Oh, wait, no, here it is. Okay, I found the Rapidash then. Rapidash was Baton Pass Substitute, Will-O-Wisp, and High Horsepower.
That'll do it.
Will-O-Wisp.
You can't really hit that with High Horsepower, huh?
And you can't burn it.
Yeah, that was...
I didn't realize how much that Rapidash couldn't do to Salazzle until after the game.
That is just unfortunate, so...
Yeah. I wanted way more support in... providing subs.
Sev
but...
has 2 awards. Clay has 1. Kevin has 1. Jack has 1. Clay has 2 awards now. 3 awards for Clay. Tyler has 2. Sandy has 1 here. Kevin has 2. Kalisto has 2. With these, Sev, that's Sev's 3rd. Sev's 4th. You and Sev both got 4 awards, Clay.
Pog, let's go, Sev.
We need another award.
But one of the ones that Sev won was saltiest match. And none of
yeah,
yours
I don't know.
Have
that's winning.
And none of yours, and none of yours that you won have any negative connotation.
Yeah,
because
that's
Sev,
true.
Sev won saltiest match, MHP, honorable mention game of the season, and luckiest moment. You won actual game of the season, best general manager, best sweep, and 1 week wonder.
Yeah, the only one you could kind of have negative connotation to is the 1 week wonder.
1 week wonder. So I would say, off technicality, Clay is the air quotes winner.
Even though it's not really a thing we were supposed to do. It's just curious.
The HDL honors for season 3. I will end this stream with a heartfelt lament, unless Jack and Tyler, unless Jack and Tyler want to play on stream. With live commentary.
Actually, I can make this ending a lot better.
Closing remarks.
I do. So I wanted to talk about the changing youth and their perspective from going to drawing text on every single object and surface to drawing among us characters. That is what I learned today in a theme park.
What?
I wish it was a lie.
Kill me.
I counted like 32 Among Us characters in one attraction.
Oh, that's just depressing.